Alright, what's going on, guys? Welcome to the UTSA Dynasty. This is Season 3 off-season. We're preparing for Season 4. We're taking this season out and entering the next chapter in the UTSA Dynasty. What's going on, guys? Welcome to tonight's live stream. And for the next couple hours, 2 to 3 hours, I guessed before, we're going to be doing the off-season festivities for the UTSA Dynasty, including doing all the recruiting and finalizing the recruiting class, and then reordering the depth chart and getting the team ready for Season 4. We're going to get all the way up to Week 1. We're not going to play Week 1, but we're going to, you know, get to that stage. And so I'm just making sure everything is all set here. The settings are right. I want to make sure I didn't mess anything up this time. And I really think everything's working right now, and I'm not sure where the best place is to put my camera. I just put it here so you could read off season 2014. So, oh boy. Alright. And I got the UTSA shirt just specially for the live stream tonight. I changed shirts out of my Antoine Winfield shirt so I could wear it for the stream and be in the UTSA team spirit. So before we move on to the off season, let's recap and look at the season statistics and try to remember some of the guys that are going to be leaving. Holy crap, already 242 people watching. That's pretty sick. Before my view count is even updated on the UTSA on the thing. Team spirit, so awesome. Let me make sure. Let's recap. Where is that sound coming from? Where are you hiding? Mute. I don't want any sort of echo. Alright, guys. So let's just, I'm going to make a list here of all the seniors that are gone. We got John Simmons, of course. And he only finished his career with 4 touchdown passes. Didn't get to play much. He was behind Derek Soza and then behind Devin Newton and started 2 or 3 games. I forget exactly. 342 people. Hurricane, I had to Mission Impossible getting to Albertsons and back before the stream. Literally just got here 2 minutes ago. Is that like a rest, like a grocery store? I don't know exactly what Albertsons is. Better hit that capture. I'm gonna hit capture in a sec. Don't let me forget. Alright, I'm not gonna write it down actually. We're losing David Glasgow, remember the senior, and then we still have Anthony Banks. Richie Battle was a freshman. And we also have Danny Moss as a redshirted freshman. Receiving wise, Cam Jones, farewell. David Morgan, goodbye. Kenny Harrison will be back for one more season. Tim Whitaker's a freshman. Brandon Freeman's a senior. Okay, Jason Todd was a redshirt freshman. I had got him myself. Randy Jones, Danny Moss, Richie Battle. On the line, well, the senior that gave up 10 sacks is gone. David Morgan had 0 sacks given up at tight end. Peyton Ryan, a senior's gone. Drew Phillips, gone. You can see a lot of seniors. Remember, 24 guys are now gone. Because when UTSA began their program, it was, well, we've had 3 years in the FBS on here, and they had 1 year in the FCS before this game was out. So this is the time where all the original Roadrunners really are going to be gone. And so Nick Johnston, Cody Rogers, man, I'm going to miss these guys. Tristan Wade, both safeties. Jeremy Hall, two of our top corners, and Jeremy Hall and Darian Starling. Replacing them with some taller guys, though, don't worry. We like Kyle Nichols with his 6 interceptions this year. John Walker had a good first year starting, but he's going to be gone. Richard Burge, Jason Neal. Okay, Jason Holmes is staying. Sean Hunter is staying. Adiki's staying. Mabry's gone. Mike Butler still here. Andre Ross was a true freshman. Singletary is a senior and he's gone. Man, you can see all these guys that are leaving. And I wish I wouldn't have fast forwarded through the simulation so much. So I could have shown you guys the rest of the bowl games and stuff. Your whole O-line is gone next year. Basically, but I have a lot of tackles like built up redshirted wise and a lot of redshirt freshmen this year. Our kicker, Sean Iano, is gone. Our punter, Chris Conley, is gone. So that's 24 guys. That sounds weird when you say it two words in succession that have different meanings. Basically, well, not different meanings, just referring to different things. But all right, I'm going to hit capture right now. We got almost 500 people in here already. That's pretty awesome that I can pull 500 people into an off-season stream. If you guys could please leave a like, I would really appreciate it. So we're about to get into the off season. Now, let me make sure. I want to see where my setting is for autosave, because I just don't want to mess this next step up and, like, ruin the entire series. I think I already took it off, though. I gotta remember. Is it under... I thought it was under system settings. Maybe it's under dynasty setup. Actually... What the hell? Oh, autosave off. Okay. I found it. Alright, so say goodbye, guys, to Season 3 in the UTSA Dynasty. I'm going to miss all those guys. They'll pave the way to make this team bowl eligible for the first time. Go 8-4, 4-4 in conference. Let's go to Season 5, guys. 500 people, let's go to Season 4. Player, okay. We're advancing to players leaving, actually. I've already done my contract. Oh, and tonight, I got some G Fuel right here, and like I said, I'm starting to feel sick, so I'm like trying to load up on vitamin C, and so I bought some Sunny Delight today. But actually, G Fuel, this has a bunch of vitamin C in it, too. I don't know if that's actually going to help anything, but in my mind, it does. I'm self-treating myself. Oh, everybody's saying bye. I'm like, what the hell? You guys literally are all saying bye to Season 3. It's pretty awesome. Alright. Grab some Kleenex. Oh, man. Alright, players leaving. Get ready for this list. I've already listed all of them, by the way. No one's leaving early, right? Oh, whoa, ho, 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 ho. Wait a minute here. That's the guy that I wanted to replace David Morgan with. And he wants to transfer to Houston? I don't think so. You will catch 30 passes. Wait. Persuasion chance very, very low. Oh, I done goofed. I shouldn't have redshirted him. He's gonna go to Houston? Dude, you're the 67 overall. You've been on the bench till you're a junior. You will play in more than 9 games. I don't know, coach. There are positives and negatives to both directions. And you're going to catch 30 passes. I don't feel like I'm part of the team. I need a fresh start. Shoot. This guy was supposed to be the replacement receiving tight end for David Morgan. Do we have to start the Kyle Allen rivalry now, all of a sudden? Let me see. Let me try to find more about this kid. Let me show you guys his skills. 80 speed and 86 acceleration, 75 catching. He's the receiving tight end I really wanted. You're staying, Kyle. You better stay. Actually, Cam Jones, can I convince you to somehow finagle your way to stay again? Oh, man. One sec. Alright, this sucks. I don't know if I promised him early playing time or not, but if I did, then I definitely went back to my promise. But here are all the graduates. That is a long list. But there's not much else we can do about it besides replace them. Quarterback, one of them is gone. Glasgow, one running back, one fullback, two receivers, two tight ends, or one tight end's graduating, one wants to leave. One left tackle's gone, two left guards, one center. Okay, no right guards, one right tackle, two left ends, no right ends. Two defensive tackles are gone. One left outside linebacker, one middle linebacker, one right outside linebacker, two corners, one safety, one safety. Oh, and a kicker and a punter. So that's how many of our starters are gone? I need to figure that out because I want to mention that in the commentary I make. How many of our starters are gone? All right, so I'm going to put tallies here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 5 returning starters. Holy God. Not including kicker and punter. Alright. Advance to the next stage. Kyle, you can't leave me. Oh, man. That is crazy. All right, draft requests. None of our guys are going pro. That's good news. Who is going pro? Wait, no. No, no, this isn't going pro. This is how many guys were drafted. Damn. Hot on Clinton Dix. Cam Jones didn't get drafted? Nobody wanted a future star? But someone from Wyoming has to go. Okay. Blair Burns, 90 overall, pretty good. Why didn't Cam Jones get drafted? Check what round David Pyland was drafted. Good call. Oh, maybe that's why he wants to go to Houston. But I think David Pyland is graduating. David Pyland, first round quarterback, is a 96 overall. Oh, man. Transfer requests. Who wants to come to UT? No one. No transfer requests. Ah. People want me to check all these schools now. I'll check a couple of them for you. Just because we're here to have some fun. Let me check some of the big programs. Someone said they wanted to see Notre Dame. They said they wanted to see LSU. Let's see USC first. Marquise Lee, first round, as a 98. I'm just going to stop on some of the big schools. Texas, Jackson Shipley. Tennessee, nobody. Really, nobody. Syracuse, nobody. South Carolina, Jadeveon Clowney. Just went pro. He stayed this long. Where'd you get this shirt? I ordered it from like UTSA's like actual like sports shop. Like I ordered it online. I got it online. Oregon, Terrence Mitchell. I'd be lying if I told you I knew who these people were. All right, Oklahoma State. Don't know those guys. Oklahoma, Blake Bell. Ohio State. Braxton Miller in the fifth round. Notre Dame. I don't know these guys. Where's Lewis Nix the third? Did he already go pro? How about the Gophers? No one as usual. Michigan. Desmond Morgan, the All-American outside linebacker. The U. Don't know those guys. LSU. DJ Welter, Ronald Martin. I don't know these guys. Odell Beckham, I know who that is. Georgia. Malcolm Mitchell. Chris Burnett. Florida State. Don't know those guys. How about Florida? Oh no, are we working now? I'm sorry, guys. Oh no, this happened last night. Now I'm starting to wonder what's going on. Like, all I have to do is, like, turn off my XSplit broadcaster and then do it again, but that's really, really annoying. I had checked a bunch more schools for their pros, and there was even, like, 5 guys from Auburn. I wanted Chris the Dog to tell me if they were any good. And I had already simulated forward, so we're in recruiting week one now. Sorry, guys. That sucks. Holy crap, that's a lot of comments. Alright, guys. First step in recruiting. Let's see who we already have. We have already had committed 7 total players. Kyle Jones, middle linebacker, AJ Brown, cornerback, Timothy Vandermeulen at strong safety, Keith Cowan, outside linebacker, James Benson at kicker, I think it's Terrell Lee at defensive tackle, and Brandon Reese at fullback. I can remember football names for some reason really well. It's been always one of my talents, I guess. But that's what we got so far. 4 threes, a 2, a 1, and a 4. Alright, so let's go to the recruiting board. Look at all these soft commits. That's what I like to see. Alright, so first things first. We know we gotta replace Cody Rogers, and I already have a prime prospect for that. His name is Chris Washington out of California. Run stopper. And we are way ahead of the pack. I've worked a lot of time to get this guy number one, us to be number one for him. 82 speed, 79 hit power, 87 tackling. He's fast. Hopefully he can cover well. I'm not scouting him anymore because I already know I want him, so I don't want to waste the scouting points. But I always give him the full offer. Ooh, we gotta give him a visit. Come down week one, that's how much we like you. Playing time. Man, Washington's gonna give you A+ as well. Coach stability. We're very stable with our coaching situation. And proximity to home. I don't like how I can talk about that and still get a good amount of points. Like, I got 38 points, even though I'm not close to California. Alright, so hopefully he commits soon. He's the man. Now we got Josh Johnson, Cedric Parker, and Brandon Ford on the list as well. Take a look at Ford. We are well ahead of everybody, too. 660 points is the second place team. He is not quite as good as Keith Washington, but he's still got a very good set of skills. I'm not sure if I've already promised him that he'll get immediate playing time, but I would not mind redshirting him. But actually, we don't have any outside linebackers returning as starters, so actually he could start too. Oh, by the way, is my camera in a good spot? I don't want to cover up anything important. I think it's good where it is. How late am I, Hurricane? I've been going for about 20 minutes already. You haven't really missed much. Or Chris Washington, not Keith Washington. You gotta visit. Same day. You visit the same day as Chris Washington. You guys can get to know each other. Alright, 272 points. Alright, let's skip over outside linebackers for a little while. Let's see how we're doing at defensive tackle. Now, we did have two guys who were freshmen this year. I think I ended up redshirting one of them, and Kellen Thomas did play. But then we got Terrell Lee, who is more of a nose tackle, developmental type of prospect. He's already committed. And let's take a look at his skill set. Slow, and not really all that talented. He's a hole plugger, but hopefully that with a year of redshirting and maybe some playing time, he can eventually contribute or be a rotational guy. Here's next guy, Eric Crenshaw. And actually, he has pretty good size coming into college at 288. Most of the guys I look at are undersized, and he's just an okay prospect. He would fill in probably well for Mabry or Burge. Is there really this much people in here? Yeah, there is a lot of people that are really liking these live streams. Like the last time I did the off-season stream, I think I maxed out over 1,000 viewers. People really enjoyed that. And that's pretty awesome because like there's not actual gameplay here. You're watching me prepare a team, basically. And I love that there's a huge demand for that and that you guys really want to see that. Talk some crap about Southern Mississippi. Nothing wrong with Southern Miss. Nothing wrong with Brett Favre's territory. Alright, Nate Church. I have not really done anything for this guy all year. I've just kind of had him on my board. He's just kind of there. Like, to me, he's like, if I need someone to fill in the rest of the recruiting class, he's one of the guys I look at. So now let's go look at some of the offensive players. I've been looking at a couple of running backs to be rotational guys or change of pace backs. And these guys are both actually pretty fast. I don't have any big bruisers at running back. Kind of wish I did. Maybe I'll do some scouting and try to get somebody. No draft picks, by the way, guys. For those who are asking, no one got drafted. Not even Cameron Jones. Alright, how far behind are we? Oh, only by 40 points on Brant Breedlove, so that doesn't mean a thing. Skills, 85 speed, 91 acceleration, not a great blocker, but, you know, he'd probably do alright. Are you going to a 3-4 defense? I'll give you guys my my thoughts and my plan once we get the recruiting class finalized and I'm starting to reorder the depth chart. I have an idea for what I want to do, but I want to see what I get to work with. I have a plan, but it's going to be whether or not we get all the guys I hope we get. Chris Washington will be the main centerpiece in this defense. Or he will be one of the reasons we switch to it. Or add it, I guess. There's a little hint. You guys probably already know what I'm talking about. This guy is just kind of like the same thing. Probably end up redshirting both of them. Alright. Hopefully next week some guys actually commit. I had a lot of soft commits too, so I'm prepared for a huge influx of committing. Fullbacks, Reese has already signed on. Darian Rolls. I'm messing up tonight with some of these names. We're going against Florida State to get this guy, too. Now I really want to get him. Florida State can't have him. Hopefully he didn't watch the bowl game. I don't want that to factor into his decision. Will you change any conferences? Probably not this year. Tight ends? Well, with Kyle Allen supposedly gone now, we have some work to do. Oliver Carter. Oh god, he's got D speed. I think he's one of the guys I wanted because he was a blocking tight end, but let me scout him. How fast are you, Oliver? Don't say you're actually a D. 74. Okay, that's not bad, but you're just going to be a second tight end most sets. We're taking you from Houston because they already took our last tight end. Maybe that's what we get for wanting Oliver Carter. They take Kyle Allen. Come on. I was really excited for him because he had more speed than any linebacker I've had in this series, and now he's not coming. Are you going to put Rose in the slot? That's a really good possibility, especially when Kenny Harrison's gone. I'm just going to start doing some quick calls. Just to speed up the process a little bit. Yeah, looking at a lot of guards here. Chris Bolin. Yeah, 77 run block, 73 pass block. I just want to get guys that have potential and then I can redshirt. And we have 24 seniors leaving, so I want to get 24 scholarships out there. Rose is too slow for the slot. He's like a 92. He's the fast. He'd be the fastest receiver. I've never had a receiver in the 90s in this series. Can you show pipeline states? Oh, I could, but I can just tell you them as well. The pipeline states are Texas, obviously, and I've also made Louisiana a pipeline state. Going against Minnesota for Travis Bell, just a balanced guard, he would most likely, or most definitely, be redshirted. Big 12 in 2 years? I do have plans, possibly, for a conference change in the future, but I think that bowl game was a good example that we're not ready yet. It's not time. Is it snowing there? I don't think so. Oh, my bad. I was thinking of Tim Whitaker. Yeah, Whitaker isn't as fast, but he's still really good. And my plan with Whitaker is keep him on the outside anyway. Nice shirt. Thank you. Get a Canadian. I'll look at Canadians. I gotta do some extra scouting anyway, so I'll take a look. Donnie Williams. How good are you, Donnie? Yeah, he's not bad, actually. He's got good speed and good size. I want to do some more scouting on him, though. Donnie. He's got good hit power. Not a great tackler. Defensive lineman that's not a great tackler. That's not what I want to see. But this guy's a gem. Plus 8. He just went up 5 overall. How long are you going to play with UTSA? Until this series comes to an end. I'm never switching teams in this game. I want Donnie Williams. South Carolina. I think they're looking for a replacement for Jadeveon Clowney, and he's ours. Is Newton still going to be the quarterback next year? Yes. And we're only expected to have 2 quarterbacks on the roster. And so the thing is, I promised Newton I wouldn't end up going for any more quarterbacks, and I didn't want to like break my promise and lose Newton, so we're just going to have 2 quarterbacks next year. And if we get screwed, then we get screwed, but we got 2 quarterbacks going into the next year, although you would never have less than 3, but I couldn't really risk losing him because I had a bad pitch. I really wanted him. I didn't want to lose him to anybody else. We'll get by, though. Bo Frazier, let's do some extra scouting here. He's a defensive end prospect, mind you. 69 speed, huh. Now I'm less excited about you, Bo. Hunter Grier. He's not that fast, not a great tackler either. What's up with these ends that aren't good tacklers? Maybe it's just the guys I'm going for. Alright, who else can we scout? You guys wanted to see me scout Nate Church a little bit, so I'll do that. 50 speed, this dude's slow. Yeah, he's just nothing special. He's got a little bit in finesse moves and block shedding, but otherwise, like, if I can take someone else, he's like a last resort guy almost. Middle linebacker, Bobby Williams. You get the last 30 minutes of scouting this week. He's got A speed, supposedly. He can tackle better than those defensive ends. Plus 6. Okay. I want to find that speed, though, Bobby. Maybe you can be a Bobby Wagner. Let's go to the next week. By the way, I'm going to turn autosave back on. I turned it off because I forgot what the coaching thing. I don't want to mess up my coaching thing and end up going to a different team or something, but I took off contract, so I don't think that's an issue anymore. Clowney will be making Bernard Pollard type of hits when he plays the Patriots. Oh, God. I can't wait for Jadeveon Clowney to go pro. I hope that he stays healthy and has a great senior season and wins the Heisman. Put a gem athlete and put him at wide receiver. I actually am going for a few athletes now. I was kind of convinced into doing it. What is redshirt? Redshirt is where you basically give a guy an extra year of eligibility. Like, the red shirt means that you only practice, you don't play. And so, like, your freshman year will basically be sent under the red shirt, meaning you don't play. And as long as the red shirt is not taken off and they never put you in a game, then you get an extra year of eligibility. So you'll play for four years still, but you get 1 year of development, basically. And it's a good thing to do if you have a good prospect you want to get the most out of, and you already have a solid starter in his position. You can delay his play time a year, and then get the extra year on the back end. All right, advance. No, redshirts are not captains. It's not the same thing at all. You should get a better halfback. I have a lot of halfback options, but we haven't even seen the progression yet, actually. What all did I miss? Like, anyone transfer in, drafted? Nobody transferred in, nobody was drafted, but the redshirt tight end I was excited about has decided to go to Houston to be a Cougar. God. Why? Man, this simulating does not go quickly. Oh boy. Here's the best news of the day. Chris Washington commit. Darren Rose commit. Willie Kelly commit. Bo Frazier. Brandon Ford. Five of the biggest impact players on this recruiting board. Watch out for our linebacker core next year. How are you going to replace Nick Johnston? I have someone who is redshirted last year that's probably going to take his spot. But remember Mike Butler. He didn't get to start much. He didn't start this year. But he played well as a freshman. Didn't play a whole lot this year besides in base packages. He played when there was three safeties on the field. And then there's a guy who was redshirted that I'm excited for. All right, so week two. Hurricane, you might have a top 25 recruiting class now. All right, Blackjack, let me check. Yeah, it's at 16, actually. Because we got 4 4 stars now and 6 3 stars, but you'll see a lot of these guys leapfrog us because we've got the best recruits to already commit to us. The rest of the guys mainly are like 3 and under, but we'll see. 13 scholarships remaining. All right, so does that mean our class is 12 big? Because I don't want to have to. I know you can only have 12 guys already committed, but I don't want to have, like, the wrong guys commit first, so I got to make sure. I got 13 free scholarships, and I got to use them wisely. I'm fine with all these guys here. The only questionable one would be Terrell Lee. I got to be careful. I may have to cut some guys off this board and reject some scholarships, and then I'll look for Canadian players. So I can have 13 more guys accept. Which means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Oh god, I gotta cut some guys loose maybe. I got a lot of soft commits right now. Let's see who's expendable, who's not necessarily in need. I think I can survive with only one of these running backs. So I think that Kilpatrick's going to get the boot and we're going to get Breedlove. Because I think he can breed the love. Let's see, he's got 60 break tackle, he's fast. Not fast, but okay, he's slower than this guy. But I think he might be better. Kilpatrick. Alright, let's do some scouting and let's figure this out. His trucking is only a 55. If we see his acceleration, that's really going to be what I want. Nothing there is good. Let's put 20 minutes into Breedlove. You guys want to see Breedlove? He's got 91 acceleration. I know he's got the low carrying, but that 91 acceleration is really what I want. And he's got a good stiff arm, and he's got decent elusiveness. I gotta go with Breedlove. We want Breedlove. We gotta breed the love. Sweet. Get your own running backs. Yep, the people want Breedlove. Good. Yeah, Kilpatrick was a gem, but he still wasn't that good. That's a thing. Tight end, Oliver Carter. Trevor Larson. We gotta see which one of these guards is expendable. We don't need to get four guards to commit. We probably even need five linebackers to commit. Alright, 76 and 71. All these guys are pretty much the same. 72 and 72. I think I'm going to cut this guy loose. You can go to Minnesota now. Cortez White. 76 run blocking and then 70 pass blocking. Chris Bolin, 73 and 77. He's the number one priority. And he's also plus 8. What recruit are you looking forward most to? Probably Chris Washington. Willie Kelly's already committed. Donnie Williams. Nate Church. Yeah, we're not going to have room for Church, most likely. Outside backer. Could get all of them. Like, I think even Cedric Parker and stuff are good players. 88 speed. Let's do some more scouting. We gotta make some tough decisions here. Do we need to have five outside linebackers commit? Probably not. It just keeps getting better. Look at that acceleration. That acceleration cannot be denied. But do we need Josh Johnson? He doesn't look as important. Well, you say hello to Denmark. Hello to Denmark and anybody that's across the pond watching this at the wee hours in the morning. Ugh. Chris Washington made a Twitter. I was waiting for it. He hasn't followed me yet. Keep Parker. Should I get rid of Johnson? Because then I could potentially have four of these outside linebackers. Start two of them, maybe. And redshirt two of them. Let's come back to this. We'll see. Is there any position that's really overloaded? A couple athletes. I should probably scout these guys more. Keep them both, keep them both. Create a Canadian, cut Johnson. I'd say remove Johnson. Johnson is the weakest of the two. Keep Parker and Johnson sucks. Say hi to Ireland. Hello, Ireland. Alright, so what is this guy? He's got 78 speed. We know he's not a receiver. He's most likely at that size, a defensive end, which I'm uninterested in now. Robert Green, a JUCO. Like, you're already in junior college, just tell me what position you are. 81 speed, 78 man coverage. This guy's probably, what's his size? 208? 6'4", 208. He could be a really tall corner, or a really tall safety. And I would get to choose. Robert Green, he's a JUCO transfer. Is that our kind of style, though? I've never had a JUCO transfer. Actually, I have. Oscar Bridges. One sec. Oh, I got a new Haytel from Nottis fan. I'll check in a little bit. Robert Green. Let's see. He's not the fastest guy in the world. He doesn't have very good hitting power. He looks just like a really average player to me. Wait, 75 throw accuracy as a quarterback? Wait, I didn't see that. Oh, you're right. 75 throw accuracy. Where's his throw power? Do they show it? I'm not seeing it. Oh, it's a C. Yeah, but I don't think I'm gonna end up getting him. I'm gonna cut him loose. He's a JUCO. He's not gonna play quarterback. We have Evan Newton. Alright. So I think that got rid of a few of the guys that are kind of clogging up the space here on the remaining scholarships that I can give out. Do we take care of guard? I think we already did, yeah. Do we need three? Ah, J.D. Richards. How good was he again? +76 and +71. +2. I wish I knew awareness. That would really help. +70 and +76. I don't want to get all three of these guys, really. How good is Hunter Grier? Yeah, he doesn't seem all that great. I think we could do without Grier. Donnie Williams. I'd much rather have Donnie Williams and Grier. We'll drop Grier off the list. Scout Bobby Williams. I'm out of points for this week, so I just gotta do my quick recruiting. I'm just doing quick calls. I'm pretty much like going to get these guys, and I don't know, Josh Johnson. I think we just gotta drop him. Yep. Cedric Parker, you're gonna get the opportunity. Middle linebacker, we gotta learn more about him first. Marcus Givens. Okay. This is a 5'10", 161 pounds. Okay, Trinan Holiday, how's it going? Although you got about a foot on Trinan Holiday, probably. Yeah, he's got that A speed, that's why I scouted him. 78 zone coverage. I'll wait and see about Marcus Givens. We're in second place for him. He's a 70 overall with a 2-star only. Get people who can smirtle. Oh, don't worry. That's always in need. Alfred Jordan. From Washington State. And I don't really know much about him. I'll have to scout and make my decision in the next recruiting thing. I think Nathan Vaughn. I haven't even given him an offer, and he was bad. 38 man coverage, 47 zone coverage. Yeah, Texas State, you can have him, so when we play you, we can take the top off the defense. And I'm already worrying about one punter. I don't even think I need to worry about two. How good is this punter? Chris Reed. 71 kick power and 55 accuracy. Man. I went to the bottom of the barrel for kicking talent, for sure. Alright. Trevor Larson. How good is he? We have a lot of tackles on this roster, I think. And he's nothing special, really. So I'm not really going to give him a lot of attention. Dude, get a frackin' Canadian. Yeah, I'm gonna look soon. I'm just trying to give myself some room to work with here. I don't even think I need all this time, honestly. I'm just going to start doing 60 minutes. Just because most of the guys I want I already have. And the rest of the guys aren't exactly high in demand. Yeah, I'm just gonna simulate from here. This could go pretty quickly. Get rid of church. Yeah, I'm gonna end up doing that. Next week. How do you quick call? It's with square, or which would be X on the PS or the Xbox. Bye, you won't be punting next season with Evan Newton running the show. Yeah? We'll see about that. We haven't even gotten to see yet. This is what I'm waiting for now. The guys, like, I want to see how many points, like, Newton goes up and everybody else goes up. Because that's exciting. I want to see, like, Kyle Nichols with his 5 interceptions. Do you know Anto the Boss? I know who he is. I don't really know the guy. You probably got all your good recruits during the season. I actually got all my good recruits basically in that last simulation. 708 people watching right now. 315 likes. If we can get to 400, that'd be pretty cool, guys. Just if you're enjoying the show, I'd appreciate it if you would leave a like and help more people find the stream of my channel. Alright, more commits. An outside backer, a guard, and a punter. From New Jersey, too. Did it freeze? Nope, it didn't. Good. We're good. Alright, so how many... I'll look for a couple Canadians quick. We got 10 more guys that could commit. Let's look for the top Canadians. Any Canadian that has not committed. 5. Jeez. Andrew Ross from Saskatoon. 6'7 outside linebacker. Oh my god, don't tempt me. Jeremy Smith. Terrence Jackson. Let's look him up. Larry Payne. These guys are big. They breed them big up north, man. Chris Woods. Andrew Ross. We're gonna scout these guys. I don't want to scout a JUCO, really. Hurricane say porcupine. Porcupine. Alright, let's do some scouting. This guy is huge. You can't pass on a 6'7 backer. How far behind are we, though? We could catch up. We're gonna give him the full hour. I want to see what he can do. 76 speed, better than thought. Come on, give us some more to work with here. 73 strength, good zone coverage. You know he's got a good wingspan. Andrew Ross. I say we go after him. He's huge. Oh, man. I think I'd rather have this guy than Josh Johnson, too. The guy I took off the list. Scout Bobby Wagner 2.0. Thank you for reminding me. Bobby Williams. You get a half hour. Give us his speed. 86. Okay, so he's not as fast as Bobby Wagner. But he's still pretty fast. He's not slow. Who are those other Canadians I scouted? Was any of them safety? That's Alfred Jordan. I forget what positions they were. There was one that was a receiver. Chris Woods from Montreal. 74 route running. Doesn't break too many tackles or truck anybody. 89 speed. That actually doesn't look too bad. Chris Woods from Montreal, Canada. Who were the other guys? I think I could honestly get by with only two of these guards. Let's see who's better between J.D. Richards and Cortez White. 70 and 76. Yeah, I'm going to go with two guards. I had some more guys I think already redshirted anyway. Defensive end, Donnie Williams. Holy crap, that's a lot. Oh yeah, I forgot. Big ol' hole pluggers in the middle here. 63 hit power. I want to see, like, power moves. Good pursuit. Terrence Jackson. 57 power move. That's too much of a project for me. And now we gotta start recruiting again. Alright, so are we doing on Breedlove? Actually, I don't even need Breedlove, because we got Banks, Moss, and Bridges. If I go one more on halfback, I think I need to go somewhere else. I honestly don't think I need another running back. I got Bridges, Banks, and Moss. I got Tex. If I can get Breedlove later, maybe. I don't know. This Chris Woods guy actually looked pretty good. Let's see, Oliver Carter. If you guys would just hurry up and commit, then I could make this easier. I want Breedlove, but I don't know if I can have him. I think I've gotten enough tackles. This guy is nothing special. Alright, let's just look and see. Maybe I'll put Breedlove back on the list. But let me see here. We have 10 scholarships remaining, and already 15 guys committed. We're 10th in the nation. I'm on Heisman. 10 remaining. Let's see who I want. Okay, Nate Church, we know we're not getting you. I can only get 10 more. Oops. Sort. I've offered a lot of scholarships. These are all the hard commits. There's three more soft commits. And I do want the tight end. I do want the tackle. I don't know if I want the offensive tackle. I wish I could look at my full roster right now. I think I can. Let's see what we could use, if we need another tackle or not. Oops. I want to see the whole roster. Oh, now I totally forgot about setting up the preseason recruiting board. Yes, Cam Jones did graduate. Is there a way to see the roster from here? I don't think there is. Do you guys know if I can see the roster anywhere? I know I can see how many players we have. Team needs. Alright, how many tackles do we have? Three sophomores and one freshman. Yeah, I think we're fine at tackle. We'll have 5 receivers, 3 halfbacks, 1 fullback, 2 because we already got one to go. By the way, those overalls up there, those are the same overalls they were last year. On defense, we're going to have 3 outside backers, 1 middle linebacker, 6 corners. I got a lot of corners. We have enough defensive ends. It's under the team management tab. Did I miss it? Because team management isn't on this screen. See, I can't get over how, like, 700 people want to watch this. I love it. Did I miss the team management tab? Coach Central. It's not there. Yeah, it's not even there. No, no one from our team got drafted, sadly. I know you guys want me to see me get a quarterback, but do you want Evan Newton to leave? I can't do it. We have 2 quarterbacks on the roster right now. We're going to have to suck it up for a year. All right, defensive end. Donnie Williams, how necessary are you? You're not extremely necessary. You're just kind of cool. And what I say, we are fine at defensive tackle or not? Okay. We got to choose between Larry Payne, this big dude, a huge hole plugger, 72 tackling, don't know his power moves yet, and then Crenshaw. We already know he's kind of powerful. We've already gotten Terrell Lee, which I pulled the trigger a little early on him. I just wanted him because of his size, but he's big too. Outside linebacker, we're going to be stacked. At middle linebacker, we could actually use Bobby Williams. And corner, Marcus Givens, we don't need him. He's from a junior college. I redshirted, I think, 2 or 3 guys this year at corner. And so we're going to be fine with A.J. Brown. How good is Alfred Jordan? Because we're going to have like 2 at each safety position. And I think we could really use this guy. 57 man. You know what? We're getting Vandermeulen. I think we're going to be fine at safety. We'll keep him on here, just in case. Alright, so we're going to scout. No, I've already scouted that receiver and Carter. And I said I was fine at tackle. We'll keep going for Richards. Hurricane, you forgot to press capture. I didn't, though. Is there anyone else to scout? We're going to scout these guys, just not necessarily give them an offer yet. Oh, Crenshaw, he's already there. Outside backer. Bobby Williams. Give him another half hour. Corner, safety, kicker. Alright, we're going to go simulate to the next week now. Next year, go for the number one running back. I'll definitely be addressing running back next year, hopefully with an impact player. I just had like Glasgow and Okocha ended up being here for so long. Didn't want to replace those guys, so I just stuck with them for the first 3 years. Refresh your screens. I don't think it's frozen. It's not. A black kicker. A lot of them actually in the recruiting are black. Going with the Lemon Lime Gamma Labs tonight to get me a G Fuel. Gamma Labs is the company, G Fuel is the product. I get that messed up so much. Has anyone ever told you to have a great face for radio? That's funny. Whatever, man. That's fine with me. Alright, we got two more. Eight left. You should do an NBA 2K franchise. That wouldn't be for me, man. Football's my thing. I can do football really well. How long does it take to edit one game for you? I find it takes me close to 90 minutes per episode for my channel. It really depends. If I want to kick back and kind of take it slow with the editing, and if I do that, I can usually make it last over an hour. But otherwise, if I'm in a hurry, I could probably edit a full Raiders game or UTSA game in under 45 minutes, around a half hour probably. Depends on how much time I want to spend doing it, really. Are you related to Aaron Rodgers? No. Look at all these hard commits. So I have 8 scholarships remaining and 6 guys here on my list. I'm gonna say sorry to Brant Breedlove, and we're gonna get Brant Breedlove back. I don't know where he was. I'm just going to look at running backs and look for Breedlove. If I sort by name, he'll be one of the top guys. Alright, and now for fun, let's look at who has the fastest 40 time that's still available. Jacob Ball, John Walker, a 4-star, his brother Joel Walker, Terrence Bass, 200 pounds, give me like the guy who has the most bench presses, or the best bench press, Derek Rogers, anyone who's like 240, man, all these guys are teeny tiny. Alright, how about big squats? Cameron Jones. Cam Jones. With a C. Let's just have some fun and scout him. Who else is there to look at? Adam Webb. I really wanted to find, like, can I just, like, sort by weight? Honestly, I just want to find a guy who's, like, 260 pounds and play running back. Chris Harris. Like, I don't want a 207-pound running back as a power back. Calvin Oliver, maybe as best as I can do here. No one's over 215. Let's look at any player in the 4-3 speed range. Did you hear about Hawaii's 350-pound running back? No, but I'm very interested. Bubba Thomas. Jeremy Thomas, Brian Wilson, Luke Thompson, John Walker. You know, I'm going to look at tight end. Oh, there is weight. 400 pounds. Let's look at running backs So, like, they make you look in their most ridiculous ranges. Like, 50 pounds, this is a lot of different players you can find in that range. Both scat and power. Henry Melton was a running back? No way, that's huge. Marcus Robbins. Here, I'm going to look at the same parameters, but I'm going to add power back. 23 matches. How come hashtag Newton for punter? Joe McIntosh. Ooh, there's a 217 I saw. I just want a power back. Like, the only guy I have that could be a power back is Richie Battle, but Luke Jones. Actually, I'm probably better off using Richie Battle as a power back because he's fun. So, yeah. What I'm actually going to look at, though, is something I actually really want to get, especially now that that one guy's gone. Kyle, whatever his name is. We need a receiving tight end. Lance Briggs was running back, too. A lot of guys were running backs. I'm assuming there's a lot of names out there that would be in the NFL. A lot of linebackers, because a lot of guys play linebacker, running back in college. Especially, like, in places where speed doesn't always dominate. Like Wisconsin and other north places. There's a lot of, like, 240-pound running backs. Chad Thomas from New Hope, Minnesota. D speed. That gets my hopes up. We'll take a shot. Let's sort by 40 time. Anyone else realize that it doesn't even sort it? Willis McGee. Not to be confused. 6'8", I want. Willis McGahee, Willis McGee, 6'7", big boy. Jesse Smith, Ed Blunt, Ben Dukes, Pierre Graham, Ryan McDougal, Dave Sims from Richfield, Minnesota, Thomas McDougal, 6'8", 262. Jason Ralph. Let's take a look. I have never watched Lost, no. I wish I had more scouting time. Alright, let's take a look. How good was Oliver Carter, by the way? He was 6'4". He had 74 speed, 62 catching. Not exactly what I was looking for. Let's look at Chad Thomas first, give him the half-hour treatment. 71 strength. Not elusive, don't expect him to be. We don't really learn a whole lot there. Willis McGee. Let's give him the 40. Are you a hockey fan? I've never really watched hockey. Never really given it a shot. Can I get some speed? He's got good route running and 82 speed. It's 91 acceleration. I want Willis McGee. 6'8 from West Des Moines, Iowa. This guy's better than Kyle Allen. He's a beast. We're getting him. Willis McGee. But we need to have backup plans. Let's look at Ralph. How good is Jason Ralph? 79 speed. Alright. We're gonna still give him the scouting. How about this guy? Jason Robertson. He's pretty tall himself. He's got a good stiff arm. 75 route running, but we don't learn anything else about him. Did I give McGee a scholarship? Yes, I did, I think. Alright. Halfbacks. Cameron Jones. 4-star. Give us something important. Durability is important. 84 break tackle. Cameron Jones. Now that's some really, really good teams we're going against here. Make promise. Alright, if you come here, Cameron Jones. Cam Jones, we could get a new Cam Jones. We could promise him a game in his home state. We could definitely give him a scholarship. It's not like we don't want him. Oh my god, if we could get Cameron Jones. The new Cam Jones. Man. Cam, we're not trying to replace you. Yes, we are. Who am I lying to? Alright, Brant Breedlove. Let's give him his scholarship offer again. We get 0 points. He's like, oh, you guys again. Apparently now I'm good enough for you. Whoops, I only did one. I lost 5 points for that. Whoops. Alright. Johnny Knox is giving up football, Hurricane. Yeah, I saw he was cut today. Is he actually saying he's done now? That was a really horrific injury he had. Don't like to see anybody go out that way. What do you think about the Percy Harvin trade rumors? Nothing really, because I've expected this to happen the whole time. And I really have no clue what's going to happen, because there's so many red flags about Percy Harvin that his trade value is so low the Vikings wouldn't dare trade him for a really low offer. One sec, guys. BRB. Welcome back, self. Alright, last week of recruiting. This is the last shot. The absolute last shot at recruiting. Gotta do it the right way. I love looking at his chair too. Oh shit, he's back. Act natural. New commentator, Mr. Chair. I love the comments on here. It's pretty sweet. I'm gonna link it out to Twitter again. If you guys want to share, like, favorite, you can do that at your own if you want to. Cameron Jones Twitter already made. All right. Might be too late for him. All right, Cameron Jones, we're 10th. Oh, we're screwed. Cameron Jones. I don't know why I keep saying his name. I want to do a little bit more scouting and find out his speed, maybe. I don't know why I only did 20 minutes. He's a really good player. I didn't find out a whole lot about him. But I do want him. So which guys are you most excited for in this recruiting class, guys? I think Cameron Jones would be someone to be excited about if we can get him. Let's see if we can make any more promises. Solid playing time. We're going to say winning record versus rivals first year on campus. Because we're going to beat Texas State again. And we'll say solid playing time. This is our last shot. I'm not even sure we're going to be able to do it. Alright. Receiver. Let's find out more about Chris Woods. We know he's got okay speed. Can he catch? We don't know. At tight end, Willis McGee. What else do we need to find out about Willis McGee? Not a whole lot, but we know he's pretty fast for, or he's got good speed for a tight end. So let's just, solid playing time. We're gonna say, we're gonna guarantee a national title. No. Coach stability. How far away are we behind these people? I want this kid. -220. I kind of want to do another promise just to get some more points. But we've already said winning record versus rivals, so we're going to do it again. This guy's big, 6'8". He's going to be bigger than most of the tackles. What is solid playing time defined by? I think it means, like, starting. Alright, I guard. J.D. Richards. Probably don't have to worry about this guy at all. We'll give him a 30-minute quick call. A defensive tackle. Let's find out more about Larry Payne. Let's give him a 50-minute call for scouting. 70 power moves. Oh, he can't jump? Really? Takes a lot to get 340 pounds off the ground. Developmental prospect. There's the Canadian. Outside backer. Now we gotta deal with the 6'7 guy. Alright, how much I need to see. I got a little bit of scouting left. 8 scholarships remaining. And how many guys on my recruiting board have I offered? All right, I know I don't want these tight ends. Actually, I could still look at one of them. All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I have 8 guys with offers right now and 8 open scholarships. Any of these guys expendable? Brant Breedlove. If we get Cameron Jones, we don't need him. But if we don't get Cameron Jones, I would like him. So I think we gotta keep him there. J.D. Richards. Alright, Alfred Jordan. He's the wild card here. Let's scout him a little bit. I want to know his zone coverage. We're not going to get it. Alfred Jordan. We know we want McGee. Is there anybody on this no list I really want? I wouldn't mind Chris Woods from Montreal, Canada. But I don't know much about him. I think he's too much of a risk right now. We're going to let him go to Nebraska. You won't get Cameron Jones? We'll see. I gave him a lot of promises, and if not, we're hopefully going to get Breedlove. So do we want Andrew Ross? Let's scout him some more. Good block shedding. Alright. We're going to be loaded at outside backer. I might have to move him to a new position. Would he fit at defensive end? Good speed. I don't see why I couldn't put him at defensive end. He's almost too good, though, to be... Like, he's undersized, but... I want him. 6'7". Any other tight ends worth offering? Jason Ralph from Stillwater, Oklahoma. He looks like the next best option for me. ...64 stiff arm and 79 acceleration. 71 catching traffic. How's my tight end situation? Let me see again. Why do you need a fifth outside linebacker? I don't. But I do have some guys that can play at defensive end or linebacker. How many tight ends will I have? I'm only going to have 2. And I'm only going to have 3 if I get McGee. So I really could use another one. Plus, I could always move an outside backer to inside backer. We need some depth there. Alright, I'm going to try to get Jason Ralph. But what if I get Jason Ralph and I still get McGee, then one of these guys can't sign on. Alfred Jordan. I almost want to keep it the way it is. Larry Payne. I don't know about progression yet, guys. We're going to learn that after I simulate one more time. I want Larry Payne, I do. Bobby Williams. He's fast. Not much else we know about him. Kind of a raw talent. I still want. I think we're just going to go with the tight end situation we have and call this good here. We need 8 guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Done. We're done. We're going to use all 25 scholarships, 24 guys are leaving, and I'll probably find someone worth cutting. Anyone else follow me? Willis McGee. Excited for the new season, coach. Willis McGee hasn't even committed yet. Signing day. Alright. Come on, McGee. Come on, Cameron Jones. Cameron Jones. I just can't get over that. We had Cam Jones, and now we're going to get Cameron Jones if we play our cards right. Progressing recruits. Come on. ...775 people watching. Damn. Alright, hurry up. Let me look at some comments here. How many likes do you have, Hurricane? 464 likes, 4 dislikes. What's gonna happen with Banks? He's still gonna be heavily used. Don't worry. No matter if we get Cameron Jones or not. Alright. Whoa. Guys, that's a quarterback. I didn't do it. Newton. I didn't do it. They just gave me a random quarterback. A random 3-star quarterback. Wait. Why'd they give me Chris Woods? Uh-oh. Ross. Guys. Who is Brooks? What just happened? I didn't get McGee. I didn't get Cameron Jones. Who the hell is this quarterback? Excuse me? Was that like a glitch? I didn't scout any quarterbacks. No quarterback prospects. No! Why would you go to Minnesota? We lost Breedlove. We lost Cameron Jones to Oklahoma. We lost Willis McGee to Wisconsin. What the hell just happened? Walk-ons, Hurricane? Oh. I didn't do it. Those are all walk-ons. You fudge-packed by the recruiting assistant AI. I don't have that on, actually. Wait, I want to go back onto here. I want to see... How do we finish then? With the 15th recruiting class. Oh my goodness. That's crazy. It's hard to believe that that's worth 15. I didn't get any 4s, or I didn't get any 5s. This sucks, I am out. Alright, there's not much we can do about it now. Let's advance. Position changes, okay. Things have just gotten very interesting. Ended up taking my talents up north to play for the Badgers. Sorry, coach. You got a quarterback, I'm transferring. Bye. Georgia Tech, here I come. LOL, JK, coach, as long as we go to the Big 12, I'll be here. Alright, one sec. Alright. It's because you recruited somebody from Montreal, blame Canada. Position changes. Is this where we see the progression too? Kyle Jones. Alright guys, just hold on a minute. This is not with progression. Newton was a 67 last year. Hold your horses. But who is this Bob Young? He's a pocket passer from Enterprise, Alabama. Bob Young. 76 throw power, 77 throw accuracy. So he's not great at anything. Bob Young. Alright, at halfback, they gave us Kenny Brooks from Jacinto City, Texas, with 82 speed. Can't break a tackle. Not elusive. Thanks. It's going to progress after this, guys. Don't worry. At fullback, Brandon Reese and Richie Battle. At receiver, they gave us the Canadian, Chris Woods from Montreal, Canada. Tight end, Oliver Carter. We don't have a receiving tight end for the first time. We got a lot of guards now. Willie Kelly. Our offensive line is going to be really rough again. Left end. Oh, we got six right ends. Andre Ross. Bo Frazier. Let's see what happens if we move him. We need someone over there. We need some help at left end. Buster Mitchell. Let's move him to the other side. Defensive tackle, Kellen Thomas, Anthony Allen, Eric Crenshaw, Justin Yancey, and Terrell Lee. Left outside linebacker, Chris Washington. Brandon Ford, Cedric Parker, Kevin Malone, and Keith Cowan. Middle linebacker, Kyle Jones and Dominic Carter. Right outside linebacker, Andrew Ross, Sean Hunter, and Charles Wart. We're going to move someone to right outside, and that's going to be Ford. How about in the middle? Kevin Malone. God, he's so slow. I'm going to have to cut him. Alright, at cornerback, Kyle Nichols, now he's a junior, A.J. Brown, Jason Holmes, Alondre Thorne, Trent McGee, Ronaldo Lawrence, and Raul Tolbert. These three guys here were redshirted last year. Free safety, Mike Butler, Trey Mohair, and Alfred Jordan. At strong safety, Defamidiki? I don't know how to say that, honestly. Dallas Johnson, who was redshirted last year, and Timothy Vandermeulen. Kicker. Punter. Alright. I want to keep changes, yes. Max. Training? Alright, let's see how the players progressed. I'm going to decommit and go to UTSA if you get rid of Bob Young. Need a good quarterback to hand the ball off. Hashtag I screwed you, coach. Alright. Come on, moment of truth here. So we see our highest rated player is an 80. Alright, so Evan Newton gets a plus 5. He's a 72 overall now with 84 speed that goes up. Anything else go up? He's better at breaking tackles. Evan Newton, come on, give us something exciting. You can throw a little bit harder, you're a little bit more accurate, so is Hancock. At halfback, Banks, Moss, and Bridges go up, and Moss is a little bit faster too, that's pretty cool. At fullback, Richie battles now a 60 with 80 speed. Man, he's our power back. At receiver, Whitaker doesn't get a bump to speed. Harrison goes up, Jones goes up, Monroe and Stanley all go up. They all go up in awareness, that's good. How about catching? Yeah, that's pretty good there. Yeah, guys who hang on to the ball pretty well too. Tight end. Who's going to be the receiving tight end? I have no clue. Alright. Now we can see the progression here. Up to a 72 for left tackle. Up to a 68 for that left guard. Up to a 74 for center. 68 for guard. And 72 for right tackle. Buster Mitchell's a plus 5. Andre Roscoe's plus 4. Kellen Thomas is now an 80 overall and a starter. Left outside. How much did Dom Carter go up? He was amazing last year. They give him plus 4. He's even a little bit faster now. A little bit more aware. Hit power goes up. Dominic Carter just got better. At outside linebacker, Sean Hunter and Charles Wart. At corner, Kyle Nichols goes plus 4. I think it should have been more. Safety, Butler, Dallas Johnson. Man, 90 awareness. How good are they in coverage? Okay, Adiki's a little bit better. Alright, so that's the progression, guys. We only have one player that's 80 overall, but that's probably going to change next year. We just hope that we can carry on the success. Kellen Thomas, he's now the highest rated player on our team. His stats, 2 tackles, 1 sack. Jeez. This is going to be interesting. Now we got to cut players. Make Battle a tight end? I think I like him at fullback. He plays a little bit tight end too because he's like third tight end, whatever. He did last year in a few formations. Cut players. How many do we have to cut? Only one. Remember last year was like 11. And I think I already know who I want to cut, and that's going to be that one really, really slow. I forget what he was, but he was a position where you can't be that slow. What was he? He wasn't a receiver. Was he a tight end? No. Where's the guy I was gonna cut? Wasn't a fullback. I think it was a linebacker. Kevin Malone. Yeah, you just can't be that slow. Advance to the next stage. That didn't take long. Custom conferences. It's already been an hour 41 minutes. It doesn't even feel like it. It's pathetic that you call yourself a football fan yet still think that punting on 4th and inches is a good decision. Hurry up. put Navy and Army in the Big East. Let me check out the... I'm not sure. Did I mess with any conferences last year? I can't even remember. Willis McGee's Twitter, that's funny. Custom conferences. And someone has mentioned this, but it does make a lot more sense for UTSA to be in the West instead of the East. But if you remember our schedule last year, didn't we play mostly West teams? We played Tulane. We played Tulsa, UTEP, Houston. We played Southern Miss, I think. I think we played Marshall. And UCF. We played most of these teams. We played 8 teams. Should we switch divisions to the West? We're not going to Big 12 yet, guys. We can't compete yet. We have one player that's an 80 overall. Put UMass in the SEC and screw them over. Go to Big 10. Put Kentucky in an easier conference, like ours. Sun Belt, do you dance? No. And Rice. Move San Jose State and Utah State to the Mountain West. Let's look at Independence. Army's still here. Someone said put Army in the Big East. Is there even room? Oh, I just did it. Pac-12. I put Boise State in here. SEC. Put Alabama in the Conference USA. Put Texas State in the Big Ten. Sun Belt. The WAC. I don't think I can move BYU because someone has to be an independent. ACC, Big 12, there's a spot waiting for UTSA perhaps one day, when they're ready. Go to Minecraft, no, playing football craft. Oh, by the way, I have no BCS tie-ins, because I don't like them. Conference USA. Night games in November? Hell yeah. Start conference games. Start them in week 4. Best conference record hosts. Yeah. We'll get our non-conference out of the way first. Alright, so we're going to move on to the next stage now. Preseason. Louisiana Tech in Conference USA? Yeah, I could have, actually. We gotta figure out what we're gonna do for a schedule. I wanna set my depth chart first, if it lets me. I wanna see what our team is gonna look like. I wish I had the depth chart from last year, too, but I forgot to write it down and I simulated too soon. I remember most of it, I just forget, like, the lines a little bit. The overalls, anyway. Alright, red shirt players. Let's do that first. Bob Young. Red shirt. At halfback. Kenny Brooks, red shirt. Fullback. Reese in battle. Reese is actually higher rated. Any of these guys catch? Battle can actually catch a little bit. I think I want to keep both of them actually active. At receiver, we'll have Woods be redshirted. Rose will play. Oliver Carter is going to play. No options there. Cortez White's going to get redshirted. Kelly's not going to get redshirted. Richards will. Bolin will. Grier gets redshirted. Defensive tackles. Definitely Terrell Lee. Wait, do we ever get the big dude? I don't think we ever got the Canadian guy. We got Terrell Lee. Left outside linebacker Cowan gets redshirted. Who is Michael Hayden? 41 overall. You're not Bobby Williams. I guess he's getting redshirted then. Andrew Ross from Saskatoon. Man, that's sweet. How many active linebackers that put us at? Parker, you're going to play. Washington's going to play. Kyle Jones is going to play. Carter, of course, plays. Ford, Hunter, Ross gets redshirted. Corner. Huh. Do I want to let A.J. Brown... Should I have A.J. Brown as a redshirt? I mean, he's not much better than these guys, and his awareness is a little bit lower than a lot of them. I think A.J. Brown could use a little development. We still got some other guys who are similarly rated. This could be a very interesting year, I think. I'm really not sure what to expect. Alright, everybody was saying yes, redshirt Brown. Depth chart. Custom schedule. Let's do depth chart first. Eric Hancock? No. This is Evan Newton's show. Dallas Johnson's third string? Man, who can throw? I don't think it's going to matter. They're all 40 overall. Whatever. Oops. Halfback Anthony Banks is going to be asked to carry the load right away. Oscar Bridges, Richie Battle, Brandon Reese. No, Battle starts over you. You have to earn it. Receiver, Tim Whitaker on the outside, Kenny Harrison, and then Darren Rose, Randy Jones, and Josiah Monroe. We're going to make Rose earn that spot. He's only a 48 awareness guy. Jones played well down the stretch last year. At tight end, who can catch better? I think Todd's going to be the starter. Yeah, Todd's a better receiver. Stevens is even better receiver than Todd, really. Carter's going to be bottom of the depth chart first. Left tackle. Alright, Mike Herring and Jimmy Jones. Left guard, Dwayne Williams. And then Marcus Thompson. He's 323 pounds. He should be a good run blocker. Jamie Brunell. Let's see, I think Anthony Tatum can't be allowed to start. Alright. We're going to get Kelly his early playing time. This is like what they were talking about when Peter Kahns was drafted. Him playing right guard, moving to center once McClure was out of the way in Atlanta. And I think I want to start him. He's got good strength. I promise them he'd have early playing time, I think. Good pass blocker, need some help there, okay. Josh Beach. Am I missing anybody here? $510 likes, that's right. Left end, Buster Mitchell. Bo Frazier. Buster, I like it. Andre Ross. Michael Palmer. Get the other left end in here. Hunter Grier. Actually, he's redshirted. Or I'm probably good then. One second, please. Kellen Thomas, Anthony Allen, Eric Crenshaw, Justin Yancey. All right, Kellen Thomas, your time to shine. Left outside linebacker is going to be Chris Washington, our top recruit that I wanted. This is the guy that I've been waiting for. Is Parker available? Okay. In the middle. Where the hell is he? We have the freshman Kyle Jones and the junior Dominic Carter. We see that Kyle Jones is 16 overall ratings ahead. What is he better at? Better tackler, better hit power, better power moves, better finesse moves, better block shedder. All right, but we're going to make him earn it with his play. That's how I run things. But don't worry, I'll tell you why he's still going to get playing time. We're switching to a hybrid defense. It's going to be a lot of 3-4 and 4-3. I'm planning on probably, maybe, the 3-4 is the base defense. And in that case, Kyle Jones is still going to start. We're going to make him earn it, though. It's going to be a hybrid scheme, 3-4 and 4-3. So I'm going to add some new plays to the playbook, probably. Brandon Ford on the outside. Ooh, we got two A. Rosses. Whoops, he's redshirted. Is Wart redshirted too? Nope. Brandon Ford. Alright. Cornerback. Kyle Nichols. Jason Holmes. Not putting the safeties in there. Alondre Thorne, Ronaldo Lawrence, or Trent McGee. Dallas Johnson, replace him with Trent McGee. Free safety is going to be the junior Mike Butler. One of the guys, he is one of the guys that I recruited, by the way. So in my first draft class, there was Butler, Dominic Carter, some of those guys. Anthony Banks, Mike Butler. I gotta learn how to pronounce this guy's name, by the way. He's got 90 awareness. We've already checked how much better he is than Dallas Johnson. Actually, he isn't better in coverage, so we'll see. Obviously, we know the kicker situation is going to be James Benson. Hey, Tim Whitaker's in there. Chris Reed. Punter is not going to be Benson. Chris Reed can punt. Kick returner. I don't think we want Banks back there. He's going to be our starting running back now. You forgot Brown at corner? AJ Brown got redshirted. We're going to put Darren Rose and Danny Moss back deep. We got to give Darren Rose some playing time that way. But he's got to earn it over Moss. Punt returner, that's going to be Kenny Harrison. And we're going to put Moss back there too. Kickoff specialist will be James Benson. Long snapper is Jamie Bernal. And that's how it's going to look this year. Evan Newton, everybody. Let Newton return kicks. He'd probably love to. Still 700 plus viewers. Custom schedule. All right. So, we got Texas State in there again at the end. We could actually move that. We could open the year against Texas State or something. All right. I don't want to play Oklahoma State yet this year. I have expressed interest in playing a team from Texas, though, a bigger team. And I want to play Texas Tech this year. See how that goes. Not playing against Kansas State quite yet. Who would be... Alright, first off, let's figure out who our season opener is going to be against. Season opener. Washington State, UCLA... Missouri, Mississippi State, Kentucky, Kent State, the Golden Flashes, not playing Florida State to begin the year. Not happening yet. Florida, Duke, Alabama. We could open against Duke. Ball State, Boston College, Central Michigan. I've never played an FCS team in this series, and I don't plan on it. Did you promise any games outside of the state? If I did, it was probably Florida, but let me check. Actually, I'm not sure if I did. I'll check my promises, though. No red shirt. Game in the home player in the player's home state. Texas, 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 Texas. Oh no. I actually promised this guy a game in Mississippi. Why the hell did I do that? Oh, because you play Southern Mississippi. Ohio. Oh, I didn't promise him. Texas. Louisiana. Texas. Alright. So we gotta make sure we're playing a game in Missouri now. Hopefully we play in Southern Mississippi. At Southern Miss. Okay. We're good there. We're going to play Texas Tech. Texas State. Duke, who should we open the season against? North Carolina. I kind of want to play an even matchup here, or a team that's a little bit better than us. NIU, Mississippi State, Miami University, Maryland, Kent State. Is there a way to see how good these teams are? Yeah. Conference champions, one. You've only been to one bowl game? What can I swap with? Bowling Green, North Carolina, Cal, Michigan State, Colorado. I don't think that's an option. They're not on the list. Central Michigan. Yeah. Michigan State. We're not playing against the number 7 team in the nation to begin the year. Washington State. Alabama, Arizona, Arizona State, Ball State. Might just keep it with Kent State. We're not going to play Kansas State, though. We're going to play a decent team here, though. Not Florida State. They're a lot better than us. Maybe we could dip back into the Big Ten. Minnesota? We could play Minnesota again. Have your season opener in week 2, there might be more options. Yeah, I should consider that, actually. Alright, so this could be a potential season opener right here, guys. Toledo, Troy, UCLA, USF, Virginia Tech, Wake Forest. Who would be a good option to play our season opener if we started in week 2? The Fred Arnold Bowl. We started against them last year. Do we want to do it again? Let's see what the people say. One sec. I gotta refresh and see what you guys are saying. Yes, yes, not Colorado. Play Pitt. Start against Bama. Yes, Colorado. Check Arnold's rating and no, Colorado. Hashtag kill Fred Arnold. No, BYU, Fred Arnold Bowl. Fred Arnold, yes. Ohio State, yes, yes, yes. No, don't do it again, no. Texas Christian University, Wyoming. Kent State, Blackjack, Wyoming. Now that's interesting. Open against Wyoming. What if we... get rid of that game. Okay, Colorado's not available there. Is Colorado available here? No. UMass again. I don't know, I'll play them again. Play Pitt. Man, these comments are taking forever to load. Again. USF play Cal, Ducks, Bama, and Vandals. Is Idaho an option? Yep. Idaho, Texas Tech, Wyoming. Finish year against Texas State again. Tulane, ECU, Tulsa, SMU. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. How many games is this? I think it's still 12 games. We just don't get an open date during any of these weeks. Bowling Green. Boy, all these schools coming in like crazy. Why is your season opener in week three? I'm just trying to see what options I have. Like, what if I make this the open date? I can still play Wyoming here. Wyoming, Texas Tech, Idaho. If you don't play Colorado, at least check Colorado's progress. Let's see, is Colorado replaceable here? No, they aren't. Colorado State. All right, what if we take this Idaho game, make it open? We can play Colorado here. We can start the year at Wyoming, then play Colorado, go at Texas Tech, get our bye week, and then get into our conference schedule, and then play Texas State to finish it off. I think I like this. What do you guys think? Think this is good? Or do you not really care about me playing Wyoming? No, not Colorado. Change some games to in the Alamo Dome. Let me see here. We got one, two, three, four, five. All right, this year we're playing Texas State at home in the rivalry game. So this would be an even distribution of home and away games. Yes, I like it. That's great. It's good. Yes. Play this season opener on week one. If I can play Wyoming in week one, I will. Yes, there's still an option. We go Wyoming bye, Colorado, Texas Tech bye, and then prepare for battle against the conference foes in Texas State. Houston would be a good one again. Think that's going to be the way it is right there, guys. Start at Wyoming, play home against Colorado, and then Texas Tech, and then boom. Finish it off against Texas State. There is your 2015 schedule. I'm not playing Florida State this year, but I do plan on playing them soon. All right, now set up recruiting board. I'm not creating any prospects. Yeah. One sec. Change players' numbers. Yes, I gotta do that. Let's do it. Let's end the stream with that. Let's end the stream when we do that. Let's set the recruiting board right now. No more Fred Arnold rivalry after this year. It's a little ridiculous at this point. It's still fun, though. Like, let's see how good Fred Arnold is now. I love that storyline. I really do like it. Go get a guy from Alabama, please. I do. He's a quarterback. Bob Young. All right, so let's see how good the players are for the out-of-conference games, by the way. We're going to check on Colorado, obviously, to see Fred Arnold. How good he is now. All right, so first, Wyoming. Actually, a very even matchup, I think. They only have two players in the 80s. And one's a quarterback and one's a right tackle. I'm interested in this game now. Really interested. DJ May. Sean Cannon. I love that name. Willie Henry, Trent Sewell, Joey Fletcher. That's our week one opponent. Oh. Who's the best quarterback available? Everett Goldson is the best quarterback available. His best player available. All right, then we play Texas Tech. And they got some players that are very good. They got like a dozen or more players that are above the 80s. Won't be easy. And then Colorado. Their best player is Mark Musto. Let's see. Middle linebacker. Whoa, what happened here? Fred Arnold got passed up by Zach Reese. How come Arnold... Was Arnold a 71 before? He's not even the best middle linebacker they have now. He's in a tie for second. He could be a third string linebacker. Check Johnny Manziel. Alright, well that's interesting there, because maybe I shouldn't have added Colorado to the schedule then. You guys want to see Johnny Manziel? If he's still in the game. 90 overall, there he is. Johnny Manziel. Did Arnold go backwards in overall? Because I could have swore when I recruited him, he was like a 74. Oh, I can still edit this. I don't think there's a reason to play Colorado now. Because he's not even a starter. I can still change this. He was in the 60s, it was a 70 overall. Yeah, I'm gonna switch him. Should we go to Hawaii? No, this is gonna be a home game. Hawaii, play Boise State, play the Bearcats. Fred Arnold was in 68 when you recruited them. Oh, I didn't know. Wake Forest, Virginia Tech. Syracuse. Oregon's number one, in case you were wondering. Northwestern, we could go to another Big Ten school. Play Baylor, make Texas Tech at home in Hawaii on the road. Bama. I think people really want to see me go to Hawaii to play. So I could do that. Yeah, make this the home game and make this the road game. Go away, away, home, away. We only have back-to-back home games once. Otherwise, there's a lot of back and forth on the schedule. We're going to go at Hawaii. This would be three non-conference teams I've never played before, too. That'd be pretty cool. That's pretty cool. I like that. All right, so Hawaii it is. Let's set up that recruiting board now. I think this is the last season that will feature real-life players from past seasons other than red shirts. Yeah, that's the case. Alright, guys. So, it's time to set up a new recruiting board. We know we need to get some impact players. Some real impact players. It's time to turn that corner. made it to a bowl game, has some young guns in there, had to replace, I think, 17 starters or 18 starters. Let's start with running backs in our pipeline. Thirty-three matches found at running back. Deron Wilson, Tom Bell, Troy Butler. Do you guys want to see me do the preseason recruiting right now? Or do you would you guys rather me just do that later and put it in the video? Because it could take some time. And would you guys rather me do the recruiting? Or would you rather me just go do the edit players and accessories, and then I'll do the recruiting on my own and put that in the video itself? Later, later, later. Yes now, yeah. Numbers, yeah. Get Wilson, create a 350-pound running back prospect. This could take a little bit of time. Especially because I like to put a lot of time in my recruiting. So I could just do that later. Is Houston on your schedule for UTSA because of Kyle Allen, the meanie who left for you for the team? For them. Yes, we are playing against Houston. Now, recruit. Now, go to Canada. Later, now, later. Show us the guys interested in UTSA from the start. Now, later, later, now. Up to you. Now, later, put in vid. I really don't know. Maybe I'll just do a little bit right now. But yeah, someone had a really good suggestion. I look at who was all like interested in UTSA. So, let's do that. Interest in UTSA. Who has this as their top school? We just went to a bowl game, people. 12 people. What do we got? James Roberts, the hard-hitting free safety from Leesville, Louisiana. Ooh, that doesn't look good to me. But you never know. David Scott. Josh Grant. Josh Arnold. Eddie Tucker. Michael Gandy. Matt Smith. Marcus Cook. Al Johnson. These guys are really too low. Patrick Alfred. I'll do some of these now. Change Washington to a number in the 50s and change Newton to number 1. Alright. Let's look at players in the pipeline first. Whoops. Not that, just want to go here. Whoops. Alright, I'm going all the way back. I'm messing up. Need to look at running back big time. I'm not going to set the whole recruiting board right now. I'm just going to do some of it. I'm pretty excited for this season, though. We got some players on... Oh, I gotta set up that new defense, too. You know, maybe I should just do this later, because I want to set up that new defense. Yeah, I'm just gonna do this later. I think you guys want to see that new defense. I don't know if it's really a new defense, but it's gonna be a hybrid scheme. Alright, not there. I gotta put some new 3-4... formations in the defense, and I gotta set it up the way I want. Coach info, edit playbooks where it's at, because I want to really utilize these guys I got. Multiple D, multiple. Oh, this is defense. I had a 3-4 scheme, like a 3-4 formation, in the playbook last year. But I rarely ever used it. Alright, let's add and remove formations. quarter, nickel, 155 Prowl. I like this. Goal line, dollar, dime. .236 to put three safeties on the field instead of four corners. That's interesting. I think I like that formation. 5-2. Do we want to play any 5-2? I don't really want to. 4-6. 4-4. Huh? Could play a little 4-4 actually. I want to have just all sorts of different options. .34. We have the odd, over ed, solid, and under. We have the predator and the odd. How many plays do each have? I think we have enough. Like, I don't need a ton of formations. I already have enough. Probably don't even need all these. But we'll put in the even and call it good. Alright. Yes, please save it. And now I gotta set up my formation subs. .106 computers crashed. Make Mashburn a coach in the game. Been streaming for like 2 hours and 23 minutes. Damn. Alright, so formation subs. This is going to be a big mess now, probably, because no more two-back system. It's a little bit different. Some things are changed. Obviously, Banks is now the number one running back. I'm excited for the defense a lot, though. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. Come on, hurry up. Alright, ace big. Let's mainly focus on defense first. The screen is really slow, by the way, too, so bear with me. Buster Mitchell, Andre Ross, Kellen Thomas, and Anthony Allen. Whoops. Then it's going to be Chris Washington there, Dominic Carter, Brandon Ford, Kyle Nichols, Jason Holmes, Mike Butler, and Adiki. That's basically the base 4-3. Where's the 3-4 hiding? I put in the 3-4 defense. What happened? You guys know what happened? Why didn't you play Northwestern? Please respond. I don't know. I mean, haven't had a big reason to. I mean, there's a lot of teams I haven't played, obviously, so I don't know. I just, the non-conference stuff is always, I always take a lot of time thinking about it, but where the hell is my 3-4 scheme? Check what playbook you're using. It shouldn't be changed. People say go to coach info. I got a D. I don't think it's in this. Wait, defensive playbook. Def Malta. That's my custom book. Found it. Let's go fix this. I really hope I don't get sick, by the way. That's one of the reasons why I wanted to do the stream tonight was because I was feeling like I was getting sick and I didn't want to delay the stream. Bye, Hurricane. I'm going to bed. Good night. Hopefully everybody in the stream has enjoyed it. We got 544 people still rocking with me here. If you'd like to leave a like, I'd really appreciate it. I just got here. What did I miss? Well, we're in the preseason recruiting and kind of the stages of season 4's intro, and we've already gotten, we've already taken care of the recruiting and everything, so the roster's finalized. All right, now let's load my playbook. Come on, load a little bit faster for me. Ace Big's not a defensive formation. You should become an independent so you can play whoever you want. I like being in a conference, though. Alright, 3-4. Mitchell, Ross, Thomas, Washington on the outside. Dominic Carter on the inside. Kyle Jones on the inside. Brandon Ford on the outside. I like the speed in our linebacker core a lot. Kyle Nichols, Jason Holmes. This could be our base defense right here. Just because it puts more linebacker talent on the field. Alright, 3-4 odd. It should all be the same. Carter, Jones, and Ford. Now here's a 3-4 Predator. Is it any different? No. Four three, we've already looked at 4-3. And the stack is gonna be the same. Alright, let's go 4-4 split. That could be fun. It puts our secondary at risk, but it allows us to play Mitchell, Ross, Allen, and Thomas, Washington, Carter, Jones, and Ford. And then it's Holmes and Nichols and Mike Butler playing center field. 46 Bear. It goes Mitchell, Ross, Thomas, Allen, Washington, Carter, Ford, Nichols, Butler, Adiki. Dime 236. This is a three safety formation, I believe. And I want to put in Dallas Johnson here really bad. Alondre Thorne, Butler, Adiki, Dallas Johnson. Already set. Perfect. I'm assuming it's going to be the same thing for dollar defense. That's how Mike Butler got his start, by getting some play in the three safety sets. Alondre. Alright, this is just the two safeties. That's right. Goal line. Sure, what's out of the goal line defense? Damn, Brandon Ford is tall. I have to see what he is. Bo Frazier, Buster Mitchell, Andre Ross, Anthony Allen, Dominic Carter. Ford 6'6". Yeah, he's a big linebacker. Nickel 155. This is where I'm going to... This could be a fun blitz package. There are a lot of teams in the NFL like to use this 155. The Packers call it their psycho. I think the Giants call it NASCAR. This is where you put your fast linebackers on the field. Cedric Parker, Chris Washington, Dominic Carter, Brandon Ford, Sean Hunter. This is a great pass rushing formation. We're putting Kyle Jones right there. Man, this would be a fun. This could be a fun formation. We have speed. And then they go 3-3-5. All right, Kyle Nichols, Jason Holmes, Alondra Thorne, Mike Butler, and Adiki. Onside return, hands team. Richie Battle in the front. Stevens. Who is 54? Kyle Jones. Yeah, I'm putting some receivers here. I like how I can edit this. On Madden, you can't. Wait, why can't I put my receivers there? It's onside return. Is it because I'm under defensive players? Like, I was pretty much done editing the defense anyway. Have a lot of bluff blitz. Yeah, I think that 155 could be fun. Alright, why is this taking forever? Alright. Alright, I guess we're not going to get to edit that stuff. Oh well. Flexbone. Never really utilized much of this last year. I didn't have confidence in it working. It was a better idea on paper than it actually was. But what I did want to edit was some of the four wide shotguns, because I want Harrison and Rose to be the two slots, and Jones and Whitaker on the outside. Rose, Harrison, Whitaker, Jones. Swap them with Harrison if you can. I can't just swap them, okay. I gotta actually change them completely. Jones right here. This isn't gonna take much longer, then we're gonna get to editing some players. And this will be Harrison. I hate how long this takes to edit. Shotgun Ace. Is that the one or two tight ends? Yeah, it's two tight ends, like I thought. Shotgun Ace Twins Week. That's two tight ends, and it's two on the left. Double flex is four wide. And that puts Rose and Harrison next to each other. Whitaker and Jones right there. Once again, we're going to swap them this way. Oops. And Randy Jones is going to go right here. This is the last one I'm going to edit, by the way. I know some people are leaving because this isn't like the most entertaining thing to watch right here, but I am happy that a lot of people did want to watch this, and it was a fun stream. It's been a fun stream. I'm really disappointed, though, about Kyle Allen and not getting Cameron Jones. Those are the two downers. Alright, that's good. Make Dom on onside team so we can scare the shit out of people. Dominic Carter. Alright, that's the last one I'll do. I'll put Dominic Carter on hands team. Come on, load a little bit faster. Please do something more fun. Well, the off season in the NCAA really isn't the fun off season. Like, that's the NFL one. But I still enjoy, like, putting together the team and stuff. I understand that if you guys don't really like watching some of the stuff I do on here, that's understandable, but that's why I'm cutting some of the stuff out to just do on my own. Like, the rest of the preseason recruiting I'm going to do by myself. Onside return. I'm really confused about this hands team because you can't, like, put offensive players there. You can't, like, edit that. Instead of Richie Battle, Dominic Carter. Alright. Just for the person who recommended that. The most people in this stream at one time was 831. Okay, let's edit this roster. One sec, guys, I got a phone call. And I'm gonna take a pee break, so be right back. Sorry about the delay, guys. I had to go outside quick. I don't know if you can see any of the snow on me, but it is snowing outside. So I'm back. Sorry. Was the chair a good commentator in my absence? I bet the chair would have recruited way better. That's funny. Alright, so we'll start editing these guys. 60. I'm tired of these guys being like 60. Oh, because all the 90s are taken. Who's in the 90s then? Kellen Thomas. Discard, please. Who is this guy? Bring back the chair. Why did you go outside? I had to give my mom something. And so I had to stand in the snow. I don't know if you can see any of the snow. My arm's all wet. But yeah, it's snowing again for like the fifth time in the last week. Alright, someone said something about the quarterback wrist things on Newton. Should make him a lefty all of a sudden. Mr. Chair Cane. Looks like a really comfortable chair. It is. I love this chair. Alright, so I wanted to give him... wrist. Give Chris Washington a 55. Alright, I'll put on his left wrist. There's actually a lot of comments about this, so. Quarterback wristband black. Okay, Newton. Change the center's number to 78. 1 second. Let's see, Banks is 23, Moss is 35, Bridges is 20, Brooks is 37. What's the fullback? 31 and 47. 86, 18, 81, 88. Let's see what else is available for Darren Rose. Kind of like to give him 16 or something. Let's give him... I like 17. That works. Monroe, Stanley, and Woods... tight end, 85, 83, 87, 73, 77, 61, 75, 62. Alright, I don't care about the offensive lineman that much. Buster Mitchell, Bo Frazier, Andre Ross, defensive tackle. Yeah, I mean, I don't know what's all... I know a lot of the Niners are taken up by our ends, but Kellen Thomas... I'd love to give him in the 90s. Well, 60's alright, too. I mean, he's been 60, so... Outside linebacker, Chris Washington. People said to give him 55. Alright, we'll give him 55 and tell Keith Cowan to switch it up. 49, 57. What do you guys want me to give Kyle Jones? We also have to worry about Brandon Ford because he's starting too. We're just worrying about numbers right now, by the way. Ford's 58. Jones is 54. Carter's 59. Ford 52, 33 for Jones. Kyle Jones gets 52. Give Newton number 1. I want to keep him at number 7, though. I don't want to change Newton's number. 25. Wart, you can't have 25. You're an outside linebacker. Maybe I'll change Danny Moss to 25, though, because that's a mess. Make the fullback a number in the 40s. I think 52 is a pretty good option for Kyle Jones. We have him at 54. That's not bad. What's that corner? 45 is Nichols. And he's been 45, so I want to keep him there. A.J. Brown, Alondre Thorne, Trent McGee, Raul Tolbert, Mike Butler, Trey Mohair, Alfred Jordan, Odiki, Dallas Johnson. What else is available for Dallas Johnson at strong safety? He's never played. Rename a guy to Not Us Fan. Aw, oh, come on, man. We're going to give Dallas Johnson the 42 of Darren Sharper. Our kicker's number 16. Our punter's number 2. And we're going to change Danny Moss. Although he has already played, I never liked him at 35. I want to give him 25. Make Reese 45. I like your thinking. I like your thinking. Because isn't that Marcel Reese's number? Yeah, it is. Ha. Huh. Oh, wait, no, 45 is Nichols. That's right. He's staying. Make a tradition. Best receiver is Cam Jones' number. Whitaker, Harrison, Randy Jones, Darren Rose. Is anybody ready for the number 1? That's a big number. We're not changing Newton. Change linebackers to look scary as fuck. Plan on it. Alright. Alright, I'm going to start editing appearances, guys. So let's look at Tim Whitaker here. He's our number 1 receiver. I don't mind what he's got going here, but he definitely needs some gloves. Vapor jet team color. Not a big fan of those. Train track, hell no. Main, super bad team color. Those are sweet. Look at those guys. And then he's got the bicep bands, calf bands. Give him the high socks. I love high socks personally. I think they're sweet. Hand warmer. Definitely got to have the hand warmer. Oh, no, not the hand warmer, the towel. This is going to be like our number 1 receiver. This is a big thing right here. I love the towel. I might change up the sleeves, though. Not crazy about those. Let's see. Ooh, what if... You guys like that? This is our starting wide receiver. Let's see, how does he look full body? I don't know. Maybe the high socks don't need to be there? What do you guys think? Looks good. Full sleeves. Yeah, I think I might go with full sleeves. There's the top sleeves. Three quarters. Short, long. Long black. That's Whitaker right there. There he goes. Darren Rose. Now he's a slot. He's gonna be kind of a slot receiver. Here's the first look at Darren Rose. He does not look like a receiver at all, or an athletic one. He looks like a linebacker to me. We have some work to do with him. We gotta make it. We gotta give him some gloves. I like the super teams, the super bad. We gotta get rid of those bicep bands. We gotta give him the towel. I'm thinking Danny Amendola the whole way here. We're gonna get rid of those calf bands. Jersey sleeves. That makes him look a lot better. I didn't like the thing. It was the tight sleeves that held back. Long black. Long team color. Goodbye from Madagascar, man. Goodbye. Yeah, lower the shoulder pads. Good night to anybody else leaving too. He even looks like Danny Amendola, a little bit. All right, what do I want to do with these sleeves? Maybe just nothing for him. Let's see what it looks like with both of these at none. Or, no, you have to do something. There's no none, it's just short. He's got to get new cleats. Those aren't going to work. Those don't look good on him at all. Generic low cut. I don't know why there's no cleat options in this game, and Madden has a ton. Alright, that's good. Hurricane undergoing surgery tomorrow. Wish me luck. Well, good luck with your surgery. What are you getting surgery on, man? Thank you, guys. You guys want to see Chris Washington. What do they have him looking like in the game? Please don't have him looking stupid. All right, doesn't look bad, but why does he have those dual bands? He's got to have the visor first off. The Nike visor. Might have to give him a dark visor, because he's got to be scary. And he can't have a standard helmet. We give him the Revo Speed. Do they have Revo Speed? Yes. Of course they do. The Speed Robots just look badass. Those bars are sweet. Dark Nike. I don't like these bicep bands. It's gotta have a badass visor though, that's for sure. Hurricane has had surgery on my appendix. Man, I got some a lot of surgery people in here. Surgery on my back. Oh, that's rough, man. Good luck. Listen to Nodus Fan. What did he say? He has to hold down those massive arm muscles. Give him a snack pouch, hand warmer. God. We're in Texas, man. Half our games are going to be in blistering heat. Taped hands. What makes him look the most badass? That's why it's a snack pouch. Oh, come on, man. This is my scary linebacker. Give him a neck pad. Let's see how it looks. I don't know if I'm going to go with the tape fingers, by the way. I'm just experimenting. Oh, not the back plate. Neck pad. I don't know if I really like that. Does kind of help. Define his muscles all the way. Alright, where's his arms? What does he look like with 100? Just a beast. This is Chris Washington here. He's got to have those muscles. You know, some bigger calves. People wanted to see like an elbow pad or something. Elbow braces, Ray Lewis. Rubber pad. The rubber pads are actually look kind of cool. What do the elbow pads look like? Ooh, I like those. What do you guys think? Oh boy, 600 likes. Nodus Fan's campaigning over there to get more likes on the video. I appreciate it. Who you guys like the rubber pad or the team elbow pad? Elbow brace and neck pad, rubber pad, elbow pad, elbow pads, beast, neck pad, elbow brace and neck pad, taped hands equals badass. Rubber pad ain't bad. Rubber pads. I think people like the rubber pads, yeah. Chris Washington, though, he's got to look like a beast. No calf bands. Is that the only option you can do? Alright. Left knee. Ooh, no. And according to Nodus Fan, he's like, yeah, I need the snack pouch. No, I'm not going to give him a towel. This is Chris Washington. If our jerseys were a little bit scarier, it'd bring out a better effect, but this is pretty much the best we can do. Alright, Kyle Jones in the middle. Ooh, he's a big guy too. He and Dom are going to be forces in the center together in that 3-4 defense. Like his running back helmet? I don't. Big ol' 54. What's up with the calf bands, man? To me, that would just be, like, annoying to have down there. Alright, what if we get him the taped hand combo? But, is there different colors? No. Right wrist. Feel like you was playing dress up with your little sister having those. Oh man, give him a neck pad. How does he look with it? Actually, I don't mind it on him. He kind of looks cool. He's already got the 100 arm build. I'm going to make snack pouches mandatory at UMass starting next season. That's funny. Can give the entire linebacker corps sweet handlebar mustaches. Oh. You know, there is like no facial hair in the game. I think we're done with Kyle Jones. Let me look at Dominic Carter. Dominic's a beast. Shoulder pad height all the way. Yeah, I might go edit that quick. But is there options? Oh, you have to change the entire face. I'm not changing Dom's face. This is Dominic. Is there any other way to edit facial hair, though? Because I was going to give him like a handlebar mustache to see what it would look like. Is there no facial hair? I mean, we're talking about college kids. They can grow facial hair. Alright, someone said to put his shoulder pads up all the way. Make him look like a badass. He's at 10 right now. Here's 100. Ooh, I like that. This guy's ready to come kill somebody. And now we have Brandon Ford, remember, he's the other starter, the other freshman starter. And this is what he looks like. Everybody's got a cap band! I'm gonna give him a different face mask. That half cage is kinda cool. The full cage. Not on a linebacker. Maybe on one of my defensive tackles. Under Armour. Oakley. See, on Madden, there's different colored visors, too. We'll give him just a clear visor. Don't want everybody looking the same. What does long black look like? We gotta get rid of those stupid bands. This is Ford. Alright, can I give him all black gloves? Or all black taped? No calf bands, it's a rule. Although I think a bunch of guys probably still have them, I just haven't edited. Ford. I wish we had names on the back of our jerseys too. I wish I could just design new jerseys and keep the same design basically and just add names and I don't know. If you see UTSA's real all orange jerseys, those are sick. Rename Kyle Jones Thad Castle. Carter can have calf bands because he doesn't take orders from anybody. Kyle Nichols, Jason Holmes, Mike Butler. Let's check out Dallas Johnson. Jeez, oh my god! He's got wristbands, arm bands, calf bands, elbow bands. I need to have like a speech of this team and fix them. We need to have one of our secondary players with a dark visor. Look at all of these. Oh, he's got taped wrists. Actually, I don't mind that. Whoops. Double wristbands black. We got too many bands. And he's got two ankle braces. I like the taped ankles a lot. I gotta give someone the high socks. I like that. He's our safety. I'm gonna give him some say I was gonna give him some hands, I'm gonna give him some gloves. That's Dallas Johnson. Yep, someone just said they Google the UTSA orange jerseys. They're sick. Yes, they are. Alright, we got some new ends as well. Give the punter dreads. We need a sweet punter. Is that what you guys are saying? How about our kicker? How does James Benson look? This is our kicker. Looks like a kicker. Except for he has the towel. He's got a kicker helmet. We're taking away his towel. We're gonna give him the hand warmer. We're gonna give him the high socks. They can make him kick higher and harder. I wish the orange jerseys were in the game. Chris Reed, the punter. Reed. Oh my god, that's how he already looks. He's staying that way. Halfback, Banks. Alright, Banks is going to be our starter now. I've always been a fan of the high socks. And I want to tape his ankles too. How does the white look? Kinda look funny with those socks. You put so many bands on here. Oops, no, I wanted those. Sweatband full black, I don't mind that. Quarterback wristband, no. Can we make all these team color? Get the rubber pad? Ooh, check it out with the rubber pad combined. It's like a sick... Give him white bulky tape, it'd be hilarious to see a running back with casts on his legs. Not trying to make it a comedy. And we're going to give him... He needs some gloves because he couldn't catch last year to save his life. Anthony Banks. Coach Kane, is it true that you have banned your players from wearing calf bands? No comment. Alright, let's go to our defensive ends now. Buster Mitchell. Mainly editing freshmen. Actually, I'm okay with what Buster has going on here. How about at right end? We already know Andre Ross, so let's go defensive tackle. Kellen Thomas from Bel Air, Texas. Actually, what about Mr. 6'7"? Or is he, I forget if I redshirted them. Yeah, he is. The 6'7 Canadian. Kyle Nichols. We'll edit Nichols. Man, Nichols, you're breaking the team rule over here of calf bands. Wait, never mind, I didn't say that. Nichols needs some gloves. I gotta make sure our receivers have gloves too. They're not going barehanded out there. Yeah, put tape over your gloves. Actually, that ain't bad right there. Actually, I kind of like the half sleeves, although they remind me of Cedric Griffin too much. So let's see the half sleeves. And then we get rid of these. What is normal? None? I don't mind that right there. This is our number one corner. Why are all the Canadians like 7 feet tall? I have no idea. Hurricane, my assistant coach didn't turn off where he can't help recruiting. So now I have 6 quarterbacks and 9 receivers on my roster. Any ideas on what to do? I'd try to cut a lot of them when you get to your next preseason. That's really all I can say. And then make sure you control most of your recruiting and you can just really control and get enough guys to fill in spots. I don't really know. That sounds like a really weird issue. Does Harrison have gloves? It's a rule now. But he has calf bands. You know it. Kenny Harrison can have him because he's a senior. How are you feeling, Hurricane? You say you're feeling a bit sick in the announcement. I'm feeling okay right now. I'm not really feeling that sick right now. But like the last couple days, I've woke up and just been really like tired. Like it's the fatigue you feel when you're tired. So I'm like, oh, it could be coming. And so I'm like, all right, I better not delay this stream and then get sick and then delay it even further. So we're definitely doing it today. I think I've already taken care of Darren Rose. Yep. Alright, now one last guy. Let's look at Oliver Carter. This tight end. He's fine. Thanks for giving me something to listen to while working on my senior project for college. Man, whenever I do homework, I have to shut everything else out because I won't be able to focus. I'll say I'm going to do work and then not do work. We have video evidence saying you don't allow calf bands. It's a choice the players have. What right do you have taking that from them? this team is a dictatorship. Alright, so basically the rest of that I have to do is my recruiting board. I've already taken care of everything else. And then I start the season. So I'll take a little bit of time to look at the recruiting board, and then I'm going to kill the stream. It's already almost 10 o'clock, actually. Damn, how long have I been doing this stream? Over 3 hours. Oops. It's just like the Yankees no facial hair rule, exactly. Hurricane, have you heard of the Harlem Shake? Yes. I've actually seen some of the videos. I think some of the videos are actually kind of funny, but overall, I don't understand why it's popular. But some of the videos are funny. Alright, let's look at running backs. I said I wanted to look at some, like, an hour and a half ago. Vince Washington. Deron Wilson. Nick Crosby. Joe Gray. Joe Booker from Farmington Hills, Michigan. Antonio Manning from Virginia. Andre Snyder. Vince Taylor. Let's see what my pipeline states have. Troy Butler, Joe Whitaker, Chris Fuller, David Hunter, Chad Brunner, Mike Watson, Ben Morgan, Steve Carter. Let's check them out. Kelvin Herring, Jake Turner, Bobby Moore, Leonard Johnson. We're going to really low rated players now. Troy Blanchard, Leonard Johnson, Daron Wilson. Tom Bell, Troy Butler. All right. Now let's just look at all recruits in our pipeline. Bye, nice stream, thank you. We're down to 358 viewers. All right. Let's see what's available at tight end. Need a tight end badly. John Lawson, Chris Williams, Brian Henderson, Thomas Alexander, Paul Nash, Mike Sims. He runs a 4.66, so let's add him. Tristan Frazier, Dre White, a little slow for me. All right, now we're low rated again. Tackles. Ray Griffith. Chad Harvey, Josh Watson. Let's add him to the list. Marcus Williams, Jed Moss. Need some offensive line talent all the way around, really. Nick Ashley. Bench press is 335. Want stronger people. Joey Hughes. At center. Javon Morris. Trey Downs. Big difference between those two. Oops. We ought to get some more talent at corner now, too. I realize that. Leon Gardner, David Luke, James Smith. Cut off Louisiana. How about some athletes? Aaron Wells, David Archer, Andy Riggs, Pete Peoples, Justin Bridges. Let's see what Bridges is all about. Kevin, no, that's Chris, quarterback, Killer Washington. Look at Canadians again? Oh, man. You guys want to see some more Canadians? They breed the biggest people in this game, I swear. Come on. All Canadians, gather around. Wait, five Canadians? Jeff Williams, Mike Newton, Ryan Jordan, Brett Olson, and Jason Mitchell. Alright, Canada didn't have a lot of people this year. Ryan Jordan. We already got our slots taken care of. Mike Newton, Jeff Williams. Yeah, not a lot here to look at. Let's take a look at the top 100 prospects and maybe take some of those. Spark 100. Charlie Jacobs is the number one possession receiver. Will Hargrove. Vince Washington, 242 pounds. He's a beast. We're going to go for Vince Washington. I want to see how good he is. Luke Williams. Kyle Cook. Dominique White. Andrew Simpson. Mark Jackson. 6'4". We're looking at him. Kenneth Williams. Never gotten a five-star prospect. Sean Jones. Let's look at some fours now. I don't want to crowd it up too much. Alright. Mike Oliver, Marcus Gold, Let's look at a center. Titus Clark. We're good at middle linebacker for now. Drew Stevens, Joseph Solis, Jay Jones, Bonita Springs, Adam Landry, Mike Fields, Sean Wilkinson. Let's give him a look. He's 6'4". Mike Clifford, Jeff Simpson, outside backer. Nick Crosby. Johnny Jenkins. 6'5". Tom Bell. Ricardo Turner. Roger Williamson. We're good at middle linebacker, man. Alright, so let me see my recruiting board so far. Oh, by the way, I can scout right now. So, let's see some of these guys. Vince Washington. The power back. How good is he? How good is he? 83 trucking. 78 jumping. A little more, not as good at holding on to the ball as I would have hoped, but we didn't find a ton here. Don't know much about his agility, speed, acceleration. We know he's going to be a beast, though. Sean Wilkinson. How good is this guy? He's a safety. 71 man. I want to know what his speed is if it's projected to be a C. I'm assuming it's not going to be in a C. Mark Jackson from Fairborn, Ohio. 78 catching. Good jumper. All right. But you guys are right, we have to focus on our line too. So let's look at John Harper. ...83 run block, 77 pass block, that's what we want to see. We got a lot of centers on this list. Troy Butler is a speed back. Coach Kane, what are your expectations for the upcoming season? You know, I'm not quite sure yet, just because it's a lot of new players on this roster. Not a lot of returning starters. I don't really like what I see out of this Troy Butler guy. He's a 65 overall, 4-star. He's a speed bag, like 86 speed. Hell, Anthony Banks is better than you. Steve Carter. Johnny Jenkins. 60 release, not great. Bad catch in traffic, bad stiff arm. Not a lot of goods there. Josh Watson. ...82 pass block, 77 run block. This is like the exact guy I'd want. He's a beast. Marcus Williams. Oh, you don't give me any of the run blocking or pass blocking. Joey Hughes. He's only at 67. 77 pass block, not bad. And Javon Morris. Good strength. Not injury prone. Yeah, plus 5. This guy is going to be a monster. Marcus Gold. Tell me about you, Marcus. Don't have the good finesse moves. You got good power moves, good block shedder, average speed. Jay Jones. .85 hit power, I always like to see that. Leon Gardner. .85 man coverage. .67 tackle, that's not great. .92 speed. This kid would be pretty good. Do we scout that hard hitter yet? James Roberts. Oh, he's a 59 overall. I gave him 20 minutes. Yeah, I already did Sean Wilkinson. They already scout everybody a little bit. I left a lot of time left, too. Justin Bridges. .75 spectacular catch. How big was this guy? Was he like 245? He could be a tight end then, yeah. This guy's most likely a tight end. Mike Sims, he's a tight end for sure. Steve Carter. .81 agility, .77 stiff arm. Hey, that's all good so far. Alright, let's go hunting again. What time is it? A little bit past 10, alright. Alright. We need to get better on the offensive line, that's for sure. Let's look at 4-star caliber prospects. Any. I'm probably going to put like 25 on the board or so. Charlie Jacobs. Why is it showing? I just want 4 stars. Ryan Griffith. Cornelius Jenkins. Let's see. I'm gonna go back to pipeline quick. Look at 4 stars. At least I have good pipelines, like Texas, big one there. Yeah, Michigan State dominated Michigan last night. I watched part of it. That's right, I actually watched a little bit of basketball. Ryan Pearson. Guard. Put him on the list. Gotta get stronger. Now let's give it a try, a 5-star. Derek Snyder, Preston Quinn. See, if I run a 3-4, I want to get some bigger D linemen then. Like John Davis. James Smith. These are all tiny dudes. Jacksonville, Texas. He's got a 4.340. Avery Henderson. Let's go back to halfbacks. Gotta get some options here. Brunner Hunter. Troy Butler. Now let's look at running backs. I really want to get a good running back. Really, really do. Scout and draft a Canadian. There wasn't any good Canadians in this class. Joe Booker. Antonio Manning. Vince Taylor. Put him on the list. He's a 4-3 guy. Dan Arnold. Kevin Thomas. Kevin Walker. Jeremy Matthews. Joe Whitaker. Jacob Brown. Lee Hefner. Let's check him out. Anthony Simmons. Quinton McCoy. I don't need to look at a million running backs, but I guess I am. All right, let's scout some running back talent. Ooh, that's a lot. Vince Taylor. He's a good jumper. 92 speed. Good stiff arm. Good spin move. 70 break tackle. 72 trucking. Ooh, Vince Taylor's a plus 8 prospect. He could be the guy. Let's try to find some good ones to go after. David Hunter. Don't like what I see so far. He doesn't look very special. We'll get rid of him. Lee Hefner. 6'3", 180. Alright, this guy's a speed back. We can tell that. He's not a good trucker. 91 speed. We can do better than Anthony Simmons. But let's keep him on the board for now. Quinton McCoy. Give him the half-hour treatment. Don't really see a whole lot here besides break tackle and trucking. Lee Hefner. Good juke. Nice spin move. 88 speed. Yeah, Taylor looks really good. Okay, I don't need to go for all these running backs. Is Simmons any good? He could be. We'll keep on the list for now. Quinton McCoy, we'll drop him. Hefner, Vince Washington, Steve Carter. We'll drop him for now. We'd love to get Vince Washington or Vince Taylor. Taylor looks like a beast. He's a plus 8. I think Taylor's the number one guy I'd want, though. Is he going to get a Twitter account made already? Alright. And I got a bunch of offensive linemen to scout, too. Chad Harvey, 85 strength, show me the power, 82 run block, 76 pass block, ouch. Ryan Pearson, how good are you? 83 excel, don't care about that. 74 pass block, 70 run block. Ooh, ugly. No, we can do so much better than you. And you're a 4-star? I want to know how. Kevin Pittman. Give us what we want to see. 82 pass, 76 run, 77 impact. Okay, we can still work with that. And at center, hey coach, reports are saying you make your linebackers watch The Waterboy for inspiration. Comment? It is a recommended film to study in the off season. Yes. Well, almost got everything for this guy. We just don't know how good of a run blocker he is. Preston Quinn. We should also look at a developmental quarterback. He's a minus four, but I still like some of his ratings. John Davis. Pretty good play recognition. What are his power moves and block shedding? He'll be a nose tackle. 78. Alright. McCullum. Let's find a quarterback to look at. Need a good quarterback to be a bench player or a developmental prospect. Ricardo Turner, Seth Hall, James Harris, Travis Jackson, the cousin to Tavoris Jackson, Ricky Evans, Joe Fine, Logan Monroe, Perry Baldwin, David Hayes, Brandon Whitworth, Donnie Lumpkin, Joe Allen, Jeff Hickman, Joseph Washington, Brian Dixon. Alright. Ricky Evans. I want to look. Ricky. Yeah, you got some speed, Ricky. And let's also add Logan Monroe. Let's give them each the hour. Vince Taylor, though, that guy could be sweet. Let's see Ricky Evans. 85 acceleration. 67 throw accuracy. This guy's like a running back. I guess I'm looking at running quarterbacks. Man, that was like a waste of 2 hours of recruiting time right there. One more I want to add. I want to find a good receiving tight end. I can't recruit him right now, but man, that was ugly. I think like Eric Hancock can be the backup pocket passer. Anthony Brown. Kurt Davis, you got a fast 40. Harrison Young. Alright, we'll look at those three later. We got 29 on the board right now. Oh, I would like to see, actually, I want to go back into this list. I want to see how many seniors I have to replace. That's going to dictate a lot of my recruiting and how risky I can be. Team needs. Do you guys see that? 5 seniors. 2 are wide receivers, 1's a center, 1's a corner, and 1's a strong safety. 5 seniors. We can go all out for some of the best players now and get away with it, basically. We're only going to lose 5 guys next year. There's going to be some cutting. We got to go for the best players, basically, and try to get some of the most impact players we can. That's fun. Do you have WWE 13 for Xbox or PS3? I have it for Xbox. This is sweet. 5 seniors. I'm excited. And here's the custom schedule. You know what? Someone said go Northwestern. We're going to play a Big Ten school. We're not going to go to Hawaii. We'll play Northwestern. Wyoming, Northwestern, Texas Tech, conference play, Texas State. Start the season. We gotta go for really good players. Dang, you're still streaming? Yeah, I know. I've gotten a lot longer than I thought I would, but I've had a lot of fun. I like streaming a lot. This is like one of my longest streams, probably. No Colorado this year? No, we're not playing Colorado because Fred Arnold isn't even the best middle linebacker on his team. And we got Dominic Carter. He's better. In my University of Florida dynasty, I'm 4 years in, have 1 senior, 11 juniors, 15 sophomores, and 40 freshmen. That's crazy. So the season's going to begin against Wyoming. And there it is. When you see the likes of Chris Washington start for the first time. Evan Newton, the sophomore quarterback, 6'1", 209. Anthony Banks, Richie Battle, Tim Whitaker, impact player, impact player. Is Newton an impact player? No, but we know he is. Kenny Harrison, Randy Jones, Darren Rose, Jason Todd, Mike Herring, Dwayne Williams, Jamie Bernal, who has a hot streak. Willie Kelly starts at right guard, Josh Beach, Buster Mitchell, Andre Ross, Kellen Thomas, and Anthony Allen. Chris Washington, Dominic Carter, Kyle Jones, Brandon Ford, Kyle Nichols, Jason Holmes, Mike Butler, Adefemi Adiki, James Benson, Chris Reed. Returners are Danny Moss and Darren Rose. Returners at punting, Kenny Harrison will handle that. That's the way your 2015 Roadrunners look. Preseason. Let's see preseason polls. Yeah, Kenny Harrison was an All-American, I think, returner. Preseason. Oregon. Where are we? How come we're not in the top 25? Alright, where are we in this list? Ooh, we are low. 80. Hey, we got our defense up, though. Remember it was like a D? Now it's a C-. Our defense got better. I think our offense got maybe a little bit worse. Like San Diego State down there, B minus offense, C plus defense, but an A special teams. They got a really good kicker, I bet. All right, so we're ranked 80th, but we're still ahead of teams like these. We're ahead of Wyoming, actually, so we're kind of like the favorite on paper. Conference outlook. Predicted to finish 5th in the East. That's where we finished last year. 6th in the total conference. Heisman watch. Broderick Snoddy, J.W. Walsh, Warren Ball, Jonathan Gray, and Chase Hansen. Preseason All-Americans. Any runners? Nope. Oops. How about second team? One sec, guys. $5 to the first guy to pronounce that correctly. Where are y'all in preseason polls? 80th. No second team All-Americans. How about... Ah, I keep doing that. How about... Don't they predict, like, freshman All-Americans? Well, let's see what they say for the Conference USA. Connor Preston. Ooh, they don't give us any love on offense? Oh. Oh my god. Look who's the preseason All-American in the All-Conference. Preseason All-Conference. Dominic Carter. He is the only guy. No, Kenny Harrison is on there too. Dominic Carter is a preseason All-Conference player. He's gonna be a beast. Second team. Kyle Nichols is on there, and so is Danny Moss. All Conference USA. Is there all freshmen on this list? No. Is there here? Nope. Championship contenders. What does this even mean? 4-year outlook of championship contenders. What the hell does this even mean? Current rank. Projected rank. We're projected to get a lot worse, guys. Top stories. No, I'm not going to do practice mode right now, guys. But I am going to change one of the house rules. Still on Heisman. I'm going to bump it up to 8-minute quarters. Just so we get a little bit more realistic stats. 8-minute quarters. Oh, wait, no. Wait, no. That's actually, yes, that is better. You guys were right. You want to be your... I was stupid. Can you change the runoff? I don't think it's an option. Oh, I'm excited, guys, for this first game to come out. This is going to be fun. First game is against Wyoming, and guess who's favored? From a year ago, Banks, Newton, Harrison, Dominic Carter, Kyle Nichols. And for them, inexperience at quarterback and running back. We're going to give them a nightmare. We're going to make it tough. This is going to be fun. Alright, guys. That's going to bring the stream to an end. I hope you're as excited for Season 4 to begin as I am. The 2015 season will begin soon. I'm going to edit this down into an off-season video for everybody because it's a lot to kind of watch if you're going to watch this on your own. Not in the live format as a playback. I mean, it's almost 4 hours. I'm going to edit it down to about a 10-minute video. Hopefully get that out soon. And then I want to get week one up. It may have to wait till Monday, but we'll see how the rest of this week goes. We'll see. I'm going to try to get the preseason video out as soon as I can. I better not get sick because I want to make some videos on this soon. But, alright. We're going to get to the regular season soon, guys, with Wyoming being our first opponent. And I got to introduce the team, too. I got to make an intro video. At least that's the plan. I'm not going to say... I am going to leave out the entire footage. But I'm also going to give a 10-minute video, so don't worry. I may do a season preview video, no promise. I'm pretty sure I'm going to do it, but we'll see what I have time for. All right, guys. Anyway, I'll see you guys next time. Hope you enjoyed the live stream. Hope you're ready for Season 4. It's going to be a fun year, I think. Got some impact players out of this freshman class. Chris Washington, Brandon Ford. I think it's going to be a lot of fun to watch. So I'll see you guys next time. Have a great day. And just peace, guys.